To you, you blink and we're halfway through the week. A very welcome to you. This is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Espresso. We are live on S3 and I'm Zoe Brown. Good morning.
Good morning, Zoe. My name is Ralph, of course. Thank you so much once again, Mzansi, for joining us. You made a great decision this morning. And of course, we've got so much jam-packed into the next 3 hours. You are going to absolutely love it. Today, of course, it's the Culinary Hotline. It's all things mince. So we're going to learn differences between the lean mince, extra lean mince, and there's also Angus mince. And then Chef Clem treats us and creates some scrumptious meals from these key ingredients. We're talking about spicy mince nachos, spicy mince pizza, and the deliciousness just doesn't stop there. I can't wait for this one. My belly's already salivating.
I can guarantee you I'm probably going to be teased about whether I rinse my mince or not.
We'll never forget.
We'll deal with that when we get there. And we're also about the challenges this morning, from the ultimate load shedding sandwich to the bedding and linen home hacks. We will sort you out.
And it doesn't stop there, because finally we've got the entertainment box massively ticked this morning. We've got Mzansi's Ballet, who perform ahead of the Queen Show taking place this weekend. So let the entertain you. Of course, there's so much coming at you on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Mzansi. Don't go anywhere, because another man that is dying to say good morning to you. Top of the morning, G. How are we doing?
Oh, it is top of the morning. Absolutely love you guys. So great to see your faces. Welcome to you at home. Thank you for joining us this morning. I promise you, you will not be disappointed. Yes, I'm going to put it to you right out of the gates here. Do you rinse your mince at home? No, that's not the question this morning. We'll probably get back onto that. But not to freak you out or anything, we have entered that final stretch into the build-up to Christmas. In fact, just 60 days until that special day, and we've been seeing a lot of festiveness popping up all over the place. So here's the big question. Have you started saving for your gifts, buying your gifts, shopping for your gifts, putting those lists down, taking your kids around, making Santa's little list? We want to know where you're at. I know it was an intense show yesterday. Today, we are taking the edge off. We're going to cook a lot, and we're going to have a lot of fun, and we're going to get excited about Christmas. 063-408-8863. How are your Christmas plans looking? Let us know. And of course, we can get into our official duties right now with those news and sporting headlines. A lot to catch up on.
Thank you so much, G-Man. And of course, official duties must commence, starting off with national news headlines. Now, the Independent Electoral Commission, otherwise known as the IEC, officially launched its national and provincial election communication campaign yesterday morning in Midrand. Now, the chairperson, Mosoto Muyepa, says the fact that independent candidates will participate in the election for the first time means that the necessary legal amendments have to be made. Now, Muyepa is expecting a challenging election, and the first registration weekend takes place on the 18th and 19th of November. Now, there are 26.2 million registered voters. Well, carrying on with national headlines, the Department of Agriculture says the outbreak of bird flu is under control. Now, the disease occurred in all the provinces except the Northern Cape, and affected poultry farms have been quarantined. Now, the SA Poultry Association said some 7.5 million chickens had to be culled, and the outbreak resulted in a sharp rise in the price of chicken and eggs. And subsequently, the government decided to allow the importation of eggs and chicken meat to eliminate shortages over the holiday period. Well, for my national news headlines, let's head over to international news. And Ghana has deposited seeds in the Arctic Circle's Doomsday Vault. And that's in an attempt to ensure the long-term protection of the country's major food crops. Now, the Svalbard Global Seed Vault, a facility nestled in an Arctic mountain on the remote Norwegian island of Spitsbergen, safeguards some 1.2 million seed samples, the world's largest collection of crop diversity in any single location. Now, it's designated and designed to withstand all natural and human disasters. Now, Ethiopia, Kenya, Nigeria, and Zambia have already made deposits in the Doomsday Vault. Well, carrying on with international headlines, tens of thousands of women in Iceland, including Prime Minister Katrin Jakobsdottir, are refusing to work on Tuesday, the Kvennafari, or Women's Day Off, which has been called in protest at the gender pay gap and gender-based violence. Now, fields in which women form the majority of workers, such as healthcare and education, are especially affected. Now, the planned walkout marks the first full day women's strike since 1975. Now, women have been urged to refuse paid and unpaid work on Tuesday, including household chores. Well, lastly in our headlines right now, we're saddened to bring our viewers the news that the Guinness World Record holder Bobby and thoroughbred Rafeiro de Alentejo has passed away at his home in Portugal, aged 31 years and 165 days. Now, as we reported some time ago, Bobby became both the world's oldest living dog and the oldest dog ever. And that took place in February. Now, bettering an almost century-old record for the latter title, and the secret to Bobby's longevity is said to be the peaceful environment he lived in with the Costa family, and that's in the village of Conqueros on Portugal's west coast. Now, announcing his death, his vet said, with a quote, "Despite outliving every dog in history, his 11,478 days on Earth would never be enough for those who loved him." Unquote. Well, our hearts go out to all those affected by this and, of course, hoping for another long-lived life for many of the rest of the pups. For now, though, it's time to dive into the rest of the headlines. And yes, G-Man, the latest when it comes to sport.
Thank you so much. Well, let's work through the roster and start with some exciting news in World Rugby. They've unveiled some amazing new developments for the Men's Rugby World Cup in 2027. I think very much based on the findings of this year's competition. So it's set to expand from 20 nations to 24, creating more opportunities for teams and regional contests building up to that. Then additionally, a biannual international competition starting in 2026 will feature a top division of 12 teams from the Six Nations and the Rugby Championship. Kind of merging, we're thinking of merging the two hemispheres with two additional countries, potentially Japan and Fiji joining in. They've certainly earned that right. The matches are scheduled for July and November, promising an exhilarating future for rugby fans and I think the smaller unions as well. Now let's move on to cricket. Wow, in a breathtaking World Cup showdown, the Proteas soared to new heights and to victory with Quinton de Kock's stellar 174 in a one day and Heinrich Claassen's quickfire 90. So the Proteas, they posted a formidable 382 for five and secured a commanding 149-run win against Bangladesh in the process. So Marco Janssen with the ball in hand, superb again, 2 for 39, opening the charge and then reducing Bangladesh to 1.58 for 5. Their final dismissal, they did kind of fight back, 233 all out. So de Kock celebrating his 150th cap, displayed extraordinary prowess, amassing 15 fours and 7 sixes in a mere 140 deliveries. Incredible, showcasing power and finesse. Next up for our boys will be Pakistan on Friday. And then, of course, New Zealand, I think, still carrying a semi-favorite kind of profile there on the 1st of November. And then we stay with cricketing news. This one speaks to the broader picture, though. In a strategic move aimed at ensuring players remain committed to international duty amid the global T20 league temptations and the big money, the England and Wales Cricket Board have unveiled revamped central contracts. So while most cricketers, such as top-order batsmen like Joe Root and Harry Brook, along with fast bowler Mark Wood, have committed to three-year deals running up until October the 26th, Test captain Ben Stokes, despite his pivotal role in England's Test side and their T20 World Cup victory, he's opted for a standard 12-month extension. Then an additional 15 players have also signed on for two-year contracts. The shift reflecting the evolving landscape, I think, of cricket right now and the measures being taken to retain England's top talent in the country. And then we can turn to last night's footballing action. In a thrilling Champions League clash, Harry Maguire came good. His second half header securing a 1-0 victory for Manchester United up against FC Copenhagen. The goalkeeper Andre Onana's late penalty save also played a massive part, further solidifying United's win, marking their first victory in the tournament this season. A sigh of relief, and Erik ten Hag's side back in the competition after a year now holds third place in Group A, earning three crucial points in their three games. Meanwhile, Bayern Munich, they lead the group with 9 points following their 3-1 victory over Galatasaray. And that's where we leave our sporting headlines for this hour or so. Brand new day, brand new weather, and I'm sure a few weather warnings and some news to take on. Let's get that with Sir.
Thank you, Graham. And yes, that is the case because the SA Weather Services have warned that heatwave conditions resulting in persistently high temperatures exceeding average maximums are expected in places over Gauteng and the eastern part of Northwest until Friday. Meanwhile, the death toll in the extreme weather in KwaZulu-Natal has risen to 8. The latest 2 victims died after being struck by lightning in the Nkutu and the Inkosi Langalibalele municipalities. 5 people died during the storm at Mtubatuba over the weekend, while another person was struck by lightning in the Makeni area in the KwaZulu-Natal Midlands. Well, on that note, let's take a look at your temperatures for today. Brace yourself, a high of 36 degrees Celsius. It's Wednesday and we love seeing your sunrise views. And for this hour, we have Verity Barnes from Riebeek West, who shared this good morning post with us, saying, "Good morning from Riebeek West. Summer is my favorite season. It gives me enough time to enjoy the sunrise before getting ready for work." Well, there you go. Thank you, Verity, for sharing that gorgeous sunrise view. And if you would love to share yours, you are welcome to do so on WhatsApp.
Thank you so much, Zozo. Of course, we've got the small matter of Quinton de Kock's incredible 150 yesterday. In fact, 174, an unbelievable knock. So we're going to get into how the Proteas performed against Bangladesh and what it means moving forward. We love that. Then, of course, it's kind of crunch time at this time of the year. We kind of feel like these last 2 months feel like 4 months. We've got an extra savings to kind of get on board, more presents to buy, lots of life to be lived. How do we get there? We're going to give you some tips on how you can make those rands stretch a little bit further. Stick around.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Welcome back to your feel-good kickstart to a day. It doesn't get much more feel-good when the Proteas are dominating like they are in a cricketing spectacle that left spectators and I think commentators at times spellbound. The Proteas delivered a scintillating performance as Quinton de Kock's masterful 174 and then Heinrich Klaassen with a very rapid, as we know, 90 propelled them to a colossal total of 382 for five. Way too much of a mountain to climb for Bangladesh. The stunning show culminating in a resounding 149-run victory over the Bangladeshis, leaving fans and rivals in awe. We love it. We love it when we can heap praise on the Proteas during a World Cup. Lorenzo Darius, you must be breathing a sigh of relief because we do carry a certain mantle there. And what I've loved about this World Cup is even looking at our old foes, the English, the Australians, when they're highlighting grievances from the past, they're almost talking about the South Africans now with kid gloves. Like, we don't want to give the Proteas the title of favourites, just in case. Just in case. You guys are amazing, but you're not favourites. Are we the favourites now?
No, we're not the favourites. I love that you mentioned the teams that we've beaten convincingly.
Exactly.
You know, we don't talk about the other side of the European, you know, boundaries. So,
we're going to put that down to being an absolute freak of the history of cricket. But let's start with the man of the moment, Quinton de Kock. Is it three centuries now in five matches?
Three and a half. he's been quite well. I find it quite amazing that it's the year that he's decided to finish up his ODI international career, and now he's performing like this, and you're like, I don't want you to leave.
No, well, do you think you might pull aggressive batsman in world cricket at the moment? I kind of feel like our batting lineup balance is the best in the world right now. I'm not going to say we're the favourites, but we might be the best.
Yeah, no, definitely. And I feel a bit disappointed with having to say this, but Reeza Hendricks, what more must this man do to stay in the team? And I don't want to take away from Temba at the moment, but he hasn't been that well. You know, he hasn't been the captain
it's
going to come forward and actually bring us a 50, bring us a century. Reeza's come in. Every time Reeza's been called in, he's been outstanding.
He's given the knock, and with very little preparation. Yeah. You know, so you wonder, the mental resilience there must be on a different level as well. Marco Janssen. Young man came back into the South African fold. He was a bit of a pariah at one point, understandably so, with contract choice. They've proven by hence their position in world rugby. Bangladesh would be considered a minnow, but they punch with the big boys, undoubtedly. We're going to have to punch with the big boys. We've got Pakistan next.
Yes.
I know, a wounded beast. You can say what you want about the state of Pakistan rugby at the cricket at the moment, but they are bona fide World Cup winners, and they have that big match temperament. They often come good in tournaments. Then New Zealand. It feels like we're having all of our semis and our quarters and our finals and our super sixes without actually having them.
Yeah, and then
what do you make of this tournament layout? It feels like like an IPL.
Yeah, it does. And the nice thing is we chatted about this earlier as well. It's something that's totally different. We're not used to it. We love the super sixes. I'm a traditionalist. I love the quarterfinals. I love a semi-final. I love a final. I don't like this eliminator. We want team automatically qualifies.
We want moments.
Yes. Let's take it back to, remember 1992, you know, readmission. We played in the quarterfinals. We had all of these things where, you know, you had to play to win to make it. We don't talk about 1999. It's been erased, you know.
Yeah. I was there, man. I was live on air. It was one of the first. I was so fresh in the industry. I was still a teenager and had to wrap my head around that and then go back on air after that. And I was like, wow, so this is what the job is going to be like.
You as a youth, you know the heartache of it. But I'd love to see that group stages coming back. And hopefully we will. We've seen World Rugby now expanding the Rugby World Cup. Let's hope that we can go back to 16 teams.
Yeah.
I really hope that we're going to allow other teams to start playing in a World Cup, because it needs to be a World Cup, not a just a tier one nation.
Completely. Well, Afghanistan, the Netherlands, Bangladesh Ireland are constantly proving that this notion of minnows, maybe we need to let go of that and just widen our kind of circle just a little bit. But either way you slice it, yesterday was a moment of cricketing history for Quinton de Kock. Absolutely brilliant. I wonder if he's going to take his match bonus and spend it on some Christmas presents. How are we going to make the Randella stretch? We've got two more months to survive until Christmas. How are we going to get there?
Yeah, we'll come through right now. We'll show you just how to get there. So welcome all our budgeting champions to the building. Yes, it's time to enter the final stretch of our competition. The ultimate question is, how do you make your money last until month end. Mm-hmm. So I know you are pretty much turning into like a financial guru of late. I've been inspired by your changes. What bars of wisdom do you have for this one?
I can't take credit on this. This is now fully where my fiance comes in with the spreadsheets.
Okay, but nice.
It has helped where if you just take a look at your bank statements over the last 3 months and you go through it with a highlighter, you can get the average of how much you spend on petrol, how much you spend on entertainment, restaurants and all of that, how much you spend at groceries, because every time you swipe, it says the store's name.
That's much,
and then you can work out your averages, and if you're happy to continue on that trajectory, then you've got your pretty much your average budget. But if you want to save, you can literally just be like, okay, we've been eating out way too much, let's cut down on, instead of 3 days a week, 2 nights a week.
I love that. And it's kind of like taking accountability of what you have spent and realizing, oh, I've got some bad habits here potentially.
Yeah.
I know for me, obviously, with the cost of everything increasing, I've been constantly preparing meals, right? So I know I buy in bulk. That definitely does make a big saving on your purchase, but also preparing my meals in advance stops me from being in those moments where I'm like, I haven't prepared anything, I'll just get some takeout, or I'll just quickly grab at the shop. And you know how that slowly adds up once a day, the next day, and it ends up being quite a big expense. So I found I'm saving a lot of money by just preparing the meals that I do sort of want to eat in the day. So that really helps, yeah.
That's amazing. Some friends of mine, they love using financial apps. These apps are great at tracking your budget. You know, like how
like
you can...
Splitwise is one that a lot of people use.
Splitwise is one of them.
Yeah.
Yes, and you can always like go and have a look, be like, okay, this is pretty much, you know, we've did a bit too much here, we can work a bit better. But you also get apps that will help you take control of your money in that way, which is also very helpful.
100%. I know one other thing that helps, and I think a lot of people should try this, is you should embrace the 30-day rule, and that's before making any non-essential purchases, just wait 30 days. Give yourself like a cool off period, because a lot of the times we emotionally get invested in something, we emotionally buy, and then sometimes we have buyer's remorse afterwards because we're like, it didn't actually satisfy me as long as I wanted, or it was just an impulse buy.
Impulse. So I have that rule, but I can't wait 30 days. My fear is then it's gone.
That's true. So, you might miss out on the deal.
But I've done this where if I'm obsessive over something and I go home and a few days later I'm still thinking about it,
then
I know it's worth going back and getting
it. Yeah, I kind of did something very similar. I like this. Mzansi, maybe you have some tips on what you may be doing to help your money last longer, how to make it stretch as well. But of course, for us to make it stretch further this month, you can stand a chance to win a 2,000 Rand Game Stores shopping voucher.
Uh-huh. Simply tell us, when you're saving for something on your Game Stores wish list, how do you make your money stretch until month end? Share your budget savvy ways on our Expresso Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram competition posts, and use that hashtag GotGame in your answer.
Don't forget, your T's and C's can be found on ExpressoShow.com, and your competition closes Tuesday, the 31st of October at midnight. And don't forget, it's not about how much you make, but how far you make it go.
Get down to Game Stores, where you can make your Rand go further with 11 days of unbeatable Rand and stretching deals, both in-store as well as online.
Yeah, now your store opening hours are Monday to Friday from 9 to 6. And then on Saturday, it's open from 9 to 5. And then Sunday and public holidays from 9 to 4. So what are you waiting for? Get involved in this one, yeah.
All this talk of Christmas, maybe you can let us know on the socials, when is it the right time for Naughty Elf to return? I think I could use his help in disciplining the household. So after the break, we're going to, yes, be having more fun, obviously connecting with you guys on social media as much as we can. Why? Because a young social media star has gone big. Tyler has made her way all the way to the Jimmy Fallon show. We'll get more background on that in just a moment. It's going to be a very feel-good first hour of the show. We will see you in just a sec. Welcome back, you beauties. Thank you so much for keeping it locked. Time to dive into the world of entertainment news and catch up on what some of our favorite stars, local and abroad, have been getting up to. And of course, I mentioned Tyler a little bit earlier. Yeah, I think it's going to be her. Yeah, maybe
oh, it already
that
is,
moment.
Man.
Yeah, very much so. But let's talk about the Kardashians for just a moment. I know this one got Ryle's attention, and I absolutely love it as well. She recently revealed that she hired a Manny to help her with her two sons and bring in some of that male energy in their very female-dominated household and family. She also added that the Manny, a.k.a., or the Nanny, a.k.a. Manny, is also a good way to help when the parental kind of, they're wanting to...
play the field.
Yeah, kind of have a little bit of fun, get out there and be cool, and now they've got the guy to look after the kids and bring that kind of energy. Would you have been a Manny?
I think it's so cool. I want to be a Manny, man. That is such a cool idea. Imagine like getting like paid to go play with kids and do like rough stuff and let's go on an adventure.
Just be a guy. Yeah,
just be a guy. This is cool. Why is this not more common?
Bro, you're making lunches, you're picking up from school. You know, that's what a Manny will do, bro.
Okay.
I think you'd be great.
I was an au pair. It's a pretty female dominated space, but I think if you have little boys, get a Manny.
Yeah, man, bring that male energy. I love that.
Yeah.
And it's great that she's thinking about that in her very female kind of led space. There must be a lot of that energy. So that's great.
100%.
I love it, man.
I think that's a great idea. I think I want to see more Mannies out there. If you're a Manny, let us know when you are hiring, when you're available. Maybe we can hire you as well. But I love this.
You want
course.
Your own Manny.
My own Manny, man.
Oh, well, listen, you've spoken about Tyler, and we are so excited to see her stardom rise. Now, the singer Tyler continues her grand rise in the world of South African music and also on the international stage. She recently bagged an important career milestone and appeared on one of the biggest platforms, Jimmy Fallon's show last night. The Water singer has managed to snag the attention of music lovers globally, and we are proud to see that her hard work is paying off, and she is a true talent.
She's literally ticking off every single accolade that an international artist would do over the entire career. She's doing it all this year, G. You mentioned that now.
Where she started, that was the ridiculous thing. So I think most of us, because we see young kind of stars knocking on that door, and then everyone saw and they were like, has she been around for like 10 years already?
Yeah.
Because she's doing it all already. She's got the look, she's got the vibe, she's got the sound, she's got the production value. Everything was there.
100%.
She just hit the ground running. But you got to back it up. And the more easy and effortless it looks, I'm telling you, the more work is being put behind the scenes.
Well said.
She's got that K-pop vibe about her that she's been ready and rehearsing for this moment her whole life. She was ready to embrace it. So, you know, that opportunity wasn't a surprise. I think it came to her as it was meant to. So, awesome, man. Wow.
I love that. What was that thing about, there's no such thing as, like, perfect timing or luck winning. It's
just,
hard work meets that opening and you take it. And she's done that and absolutely run with it. Well, we carry on with some of our entertainment news right now. We've got a birthday surprise. The legendary and iconic rapper Snoop Dogg. He recently celebrated his birthday with love from none other than Step Brothers star Will Ferrell and John C. Reilly. I mean, come on, does it get better than that? Now, the rapper had attended a show, The Best Night of Your Life 2, and that was in a benefit, a benefit concert for cancer. And that was for a college hosted by Ferrell in Los Angeles. And during the show, he was surprised on stage with a birthday tribute, singing happy birthday for him. I mean, look at this.
Aww.
That is so cool.
That's levels right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, he's even got the perp draped on. Now, Ferrell obviously then later wheeled out a 3-tier cake adorned with a blue bandana and a figurine of the rapper seated on a throne.
That's kudos. Snoop Dogg has birthday cakes.
Exactly, man. It could have gone either way.
I wonder what else was the special ingredients in that one.
Yeah, who was in the cake? It does raise a lot of questions, man. But I love the fact, because you think these guys are these big superstars who are beyond just normal gestures of love and happiness and friendship. They're not, man. They are the same.
I love seeing that one. Yeah.
They are. And then another South African singer and songwriter is making history. Nomcebo Sikode is one of the powerful names in the entertainment industry. Between 2019 and 2023, she has worked with many other artists such as Zahara and Ganyani. She has also won a Grammy Award for Best Global Performance and Forbes Women Africa Award Top Entertainer. And adding to the list of achievements, Nomcebo recently won Best Global African Artist Awards at the Trace Awards, which is unbelievable.
It's really insane. I think we've been sleeping on this young lady.
And also, if you think about it, 2019 to 2023 is when the world started to slow down and she just flourished.
She used the opportunity to connect and collaborate. And it's amazing. If you track on the social medias, the amount of people wanting to hear her sing their song, famous people wanting to get that lyric, this kind of creative treatment. She is amazing. I have a feeling that the star is just in the ascendance. And I think this is going to be like Tyler. And I know I got on about this kind of the surge we're seeing within young South Africans at the moment, but this is our time. There is something that's clicked into gear for South Africa and Africa over this COVID period. I don't know, kids just believe in themselves. Young people can see that path now. Maybe it's been on the back of the trailblazers like the Trevor Noahs kind of carving that path and proving that a kid from South Africa can go and do it on the bigger stage. But we're going to see these glass ceilings just going.
Oh, yeah, you're 100% right. I think the filter really came through between 2019 and 2021 at least. And the talent rise to the top and has done that and some. And now the fact that you have your country and a lot of people behind you, the community is strong. I think Africa's getting behind all our superstars right now. And that's exactly what we're here for, man. Just celebrating superstars.
Well, maybe we need to do that right now.
Yeah.
The National South African Film and TV Awards is an opportunity where, yes, those that shine within this industry can get the kudos they deserve. But it also promotes and celebrates the industry itself. It creates those connections, those collaborations. And of course, it gives away just a little bit of pride for all the hard work. So let's take a look at some of the highlights from this year's glittering event.
I'm very excited about this. I'm very honored to be hosting such a prestigious event. And I think it's great exposure for South Africa. We put in a lot of preparation into this. Well, they're lovely performances. You know, you're presenting it amongst people that you looked up to once when you're growing up and people that you look up to right now. So I'm very excited about that.
Well, I'm excited, obviously. I always say I don't do what I do for accolades. I think the mere fact that viewers get to watch what we do and enjoy it and the feedback that we get from them, for me, is rewarding enough. But to be recognized by your peers in the industry, you know, that's humbling. It's a pleasure to be here.
We've been waiting for the local stories to hit global recognition in the continent and not need to go all the way over there in order to get the appreciation and love. So it's about time. I love the fact that this is here. I love it.
I'm nominated in the comedy category, so I'm very, very happy. Everything is going global, like the slogan says, South Africa to the world. This is the chance we get to be known in a different spaces, different worlds.
So Tastemaster SA is nominated for the best non-scripted TV series this evening, which is amazing. So much goes into that show and it was incredible to be a part of this most recent season. So it'll be really, really cool if we win and I'm obviously rooting for us.
So there are a few awards and I've tried not to put too much pressure on myself by overthinking it, but one that I'm definitely proud of along with everybody at Tropica Island of Treasure All-Stars, we put together an incredible season that was also celebrated at the South African Film and Television Awards. And so in that category, I was nominated as Best TV Presenter, which is, it's an honor. And then of course, I think one of them is also Celebrity Personality of the Year. Honestly, and I know that everyone might say this and it sounds cliche, really being nominated and being here on that basis for me is enough of a win. And so whatever happens tonight happens, I'm happy to be here.
I'm really excited for the NFTAs. I think it's so cool that the world is recognizing South Africa as a landmark place. And so I'm really excited to see so many of our amazing productions on it today.
It's very exciting. You know, having them come down here to show us to the world is very exciting prospect, exciting idea, and I'm very grateful to be a part of it, for us as South African industry to be a part of it.
I believe it's time that South Africa is actually making its position in the world cemented. Currently, you know, we've got the Springboks playing, representing the country. We've got the Proteas as well. Now here are these magnificent awards, first time ever in our country. So I believe that, you know, as much as there's a lot that may be happening in this country, there's still a lot to be celebrated. And if you seek for sadness, you'll find it. But let's be joyful today.
I just want best Female TV Personality 2023. I'm excited and at the same time overwhelmed. I wasn't expecting it. This is beautiful. It's a chance for us to get recognized. It's a chance, you know, for everybody to see what actresses and actors are doing out here, because a lot of times people are doing great things, but because we don't have chances to be given this, people never know who's doing what. So it's really a good move.
So this one is for Celebrity Personality of the Year 2023. Very unexpected. You know, I always say I don't do what I do for the accolades. You know, you people call me a celebrity. I don't call myself a celebrity. I think the name celebrity comes from the fact that you are celebrated by people that watch and enjoy your shows. So yes, it's very humbling. Wow, this is the third one for tonight. I don't even know what to say anymore.
This is the National Film and TV Awards South Africa Award for Best Male TV Personality 2023. And a big shout out and thanks to everybody at Cardova, at Tropica Island of Treasure All Stars, and all the other Tropicas that I did before, because I think it all kind of led up to this moment. It is such an honor to receive one of these awards and to be part of now the alumni of award recipients at these prestigious awards. Well, I mean, what it means for me, I think I took a moment to just, you know, thank all of the people who've supported me throughout, and especially to, as I said in the acceptance speech, to everyone who's ever felt like their light was going to be extinguished in those darkest of nights, that you may find hope, that there, as long as there's breath in your lungs, you know that your story isn't done, and that you keep on rising up every single day, pushing forward. And yeah, your time to bloom will come. So this is a symbol of that.
Oh, wow.
That's incredible.
That is incredible. Yeah, I think feeling quite emotional. I would imagine a lot of the people on the night would have felt very emotional. But Kat, my brother, congratulations, dude. Thoroughly warranted. The job that you did on Tropica was superb this last season, but it's always been amazing. But just so, so proud of you, bro. Congratulations.
There we go. And it was a celebration of the finest talent in South Africa's cinema and television. And from the dazzling red carpet to the show-stopping performances, it was a night to remember. Now, you can get ready for another year of entertainment excellence and unforgettable moments in 2024.
Manifest.
So much to look forward
Manifest.
To.
Manifest.
Yes.
All right, welcome BTS with you right now. I'm Zanzi, as I get you entertained and absolutely excited for what's about to come on your Feel Good Breakfast show. We're getting ready for it. It's a masterclass, but a masterclass with mints. Of course, that means Chef Clem's in the building. Brother, how are we doing this morning?
I'm so good.
Oh,
and
yes.
You?
I'm so excited to always have you here. It feels like the family's always reuniting, especially in the kitchen. What are we making though, bro?
We're working on the basics of frying mints. Ooh. And I know we've done mints on the show before,
yeah,
but it's such a classic and people keep on asking about it. So we're doing a mints hotline today.
Oh, it's gonna get good. I'm Zanzi, don't go anywhere. All this and a whole lot more on your Feel Good Breakfast show. Let's get ready.
Smelling good, man.
Bespoke.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Oh, yes, Mzazi, welcome back to it. It officially is the Culinary Hotline Bling! Bling, bling, bling! Yes, and this week it is all about mince. It's such a versatile, affordable protein and something you can really stretch out to feed the whole family, especially with the rise in prices right now. This has come through at the perfect time. So the one and only, the Grand Chef Clem is here to give us a mince masterclass and take mince beyond the bolognese. So if you've got any questions or culinary conundrums that you love solved, have your discussion right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Use our WhatsApp voice note line. That's 063-408-8863. For now though, let's dive into some mince. Clem, how are we doing this, bro? Let's talk about this thing that we are using in almost every certain meal.
Yeah.
We make burgers, we make mince, we make curries, the list goes on and on and on. What you got for
and
us?
And on and on and on.
Yeah.
So we get a lot of questions about mince throughout the whole year.
Yes.
And I understand why, because it's, like you said, it's that protein that gets used the most.
Mm-hmm.
So obviously viewers at home want to make sure when they're buying mince, they're getting the most out of it. So
yes.
For me, what I always think about is mince is not... Okay, another thing. South Africans believe that mince is made out of, like, scraps of meat.
Mm.
Not the case at all with Woody's. These are, like, proper round cuts. So whenever I cook mince, I treat it like a steak.
Ooh, okay.
And that way you get that like caramelization out of it, that umami out of it.
Yeah.
The mince takes on so much depth of flavor just by being mince and salt and pepper on its own. So there's a couple of tricks how to do that. So first what you do is get some oil in the pan,
okay,
and you want to heat it like you would for a steak, okay?
All right, so it's super hot.
Yeah, get it nice and hot. This works good for dishes like we're going to make now, which is nachos, where you want the flavor of the beef to come through as well. And by doing that, the only way you can do that is to get that crust on the meat.
So you kind of want to, almost like you would sear a steak, you want to sear some of the edges of the mince and really get that like crispiness going. Ah, I like that, man. I literally used this last night in a dish. I actually have been changing my dietary requirements a little bit. I've been using the lean beef, right? The mince, because there's not a lot of fat in it. Honestly, there's not a lot of fat in it.
Yeah.
Like, really, there isn't. I've had to change my mince and actually get more fatty mince right now, just to kind of change things up and get a little bit more fat. But honestly, if you want to cut as well, for those that are on, like, a diet requirement that needs low calories, but you want to get some protein in, it is such a great choice. And like I said, it's versatile, so it doesn't have to be a boring week of meal planning. Like right now, you can get so creative with this.
Mm.
I'm sure as we address things mince related, we will dive into the rinse your mince is conversations once again,
so,
right?
So here's the thing, and I'm glad you brought it up. So I went to actually visit the team at Excellent Meat.
Yeah, we saw that. That was amazing.
And I got to speak to them about that whole thing about rinsing the mince. And they said to me that it was done like previously when the mince was at full, like full fat ratio to meat. So it would be something like 50% fat, 70% meat. And what people would do then is they would rinse the mince with warm water just to let some of that fat actually render out.
Oh, wow.
However, they are so specific with the percentage of fat in the mince, and there's constant checks that happen throughout, so they know exactly what the percentage is, and they're like, you do not need to rinse your mince.
I love that.
But if it's for some, like, oh, so we just walked in as I said that. You don't need
to. Just got this look in our eyes.
You need to.
So we're stepping on your turf. We're stepping on your turf. Apologies.
We were just talking about what other people said about rinsing mince. But basically, the professionals were saying you don't need to. They understand why it was done in the past. You don't have to.
Today's mince, you don't have to.
Yes, so you were very justified in your rationality, but
we
are living in the future now, so you never have to do it again.
Thank you.
We got you.
I appreciate it. I'll be back for the culinary hotline.
No, there we'll see. Guys, Zoe's all on us, but I love that. And that's a great point to note, because seeing you in the factory, seeing the quality of the meat, seeing that they don't add these funny bits in, they're not plumping it with like extra moisture like you see in certain steaks and meats as well. So I absolutely love this. Kudos to that. And the fact that obviously it's real quality meat that they're using. This is the best part about it.
That's it. That's the best quality. And that's why we end up with the result right here.
Yeah. So Cooking how are we doing here, bro?
Result right here. You can see I've got like crustification happening.
Mm, and you want that, right?
You want that. Because once the mince went into the pan, I did nothing, right? I let the mince do its thing.
Woo.
And just start like browning off by itself. And that's it. That's how you know you did it right.
That's how you do it.
Don't play.
Let me just get that,
thank
that
you.
For you,
thank
my friend. Pump
okay.
it out.
So what I'm gonna see if you can actually try this. You wanna try it?
Ooh, okay.
Get this going for a little bit. Get some of that oil in there. Because essentially all it is, it's the oil that I've added that starts vaporizing.
And you got that little like flick of the wrist.
The flip of the wrist. Okay.
Flick of the wrist.
So what you're doing is you're gonna kind of hold it, tilt it slightly towards the burner, and just do a little flip. There should be enough moisture.
You want me to do this? Guys, step back. Step back, everybody. All right, so getting a bit of that.
Yes, I can see it happening. Yes, yes.
Oh.
And a bit more.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
Yes, yes. Come on, come on.
Use your strong hand. Use your strong hand. He got it, right?
He got a little bit of flip.
He got it.
That's a master class of mints right there. How to get your flambé on.
There we go.
And show off with the guests. I love that.
You've got your mints super crispy. You can do whatever you want with it right now. Lasagna, you can turn it into cottage pie. You can do whatever. So I'm going to do a quick and easy nachos using Willy's mild salsa.
Oh, nice.
Don't like stress. Don't go.
So I don't need to chop anything up. I don't need tomatoes. I don't need to clean up some onions or anything. It's all in there. Sorted.
This is just the salsa, salt, and pepper, honestly.
Oh, okay.
I mean, everything's in there already. So you got all those flavors happening.
Nice. Again. Jalapenos, onions, paprika, cumin, oregano, tomatoes. Come on.
You can smell
on.
It, right? You can smell
obviously
it.
A little bit of hint of chili in there, too. So we're bringing the authentic Mexican to this. Okay.
Can you bring those nachos just very quickly, Ralph?
Nacho chips coming in.
We're going to do nachos like espresso style, very quick.
I love that, yeah.
Put your nachos on a little tray. Get it in the oven. Just get it in our pizza oven. Just to do the thing real quick.
Excuse-moi.
You don't need that much time. You just want to heat up the oils inside that.
You don't chuck on any cheese first? You do that afterwards?
We can do it. Do you want to do it now?
Yeah, come on, man. We do it now and afterwards.
When the nature boy says.
Yeah, you know what I mean, man.
There we go.
You know what I mean? Jeez, that thing's already getting hot.
It's pumping.
Yeah, I love like a little bit of crispy cheese, and then right at the end you put some like fresh cheese on top.
Yes.
A little bit of best of both right there. I like that.
Okay, back into the uni. I'm supposed to use this. I'm just gonna build it on that tray. It's gonna be amazing.
So essentially, this part of the sort of crisping up of the nachos, you can do this anywhere you want. Air fryer, pizza oven, normal oven. Put it on grill, bake. What do you do?
You can. If it's gonna be in the oven, I'll pop the grill on.
Okay.
Remember when you're using the grill at home? Keep an eye on it. Don't walk away.
Yeah, I've done this more than once. Already you can see some of the smoke coming through here.
This is why you don't. When you are working with the grill. Look, we are here to be real with you, South Africa. You learn from our mistakes.
Keep your eye on it. That's an important point right there.
When you're busy with the grill, don't walk away because things catch fire very quickly. Okay? So
I love that. But I love also the fact that we got this authentic smokiness in the kitchen right now. So maybe that adds the ambiance. I like that.
That's how our chefs get people to come to restaurants. When something burns, we just put on the menu.
Ooh, there's
smoked.
Oh, yes.
Smoked.
Smoked. I love that. So we've got some smoked nachos going into the oven dish right now.
We've
got some of that pre-malted cheese, just putting it all together.
And it's weird.
I absolutely love.
Once you heat up the oils inside your corn chips, you can smell the corn.
Yeah, it kind of like releases. I've got a question, though, because I know a lot of us get to this point where you've got your mince on here, you've got the nachos and the cheese, which is kind of like your essentials, but then we've got to put some of our, like, sort of flambé items, the things that make us want to love nachos. G-Man's coming in, Yano, because he's a nacho fiend, bro. How do you like your nachos? What do you normally add on
those? First of all, I like to be able to eat them, okay, which is why I've retimed my fast so that I can eat on a culinary hotline day.
So we're breaking the fast here.
I can eat today, which is absolutely fantastic. I think a bit of guac, definitely.
Yeah.
I kind of like the heat with my nachos, so maybe some jalapenos, a bit of a pickled jalapeno in the mix there. Like that. For me, it's all about the crunch versus the texture comparison. So
I feel you.
Bro, you're going to love the salsa mix, though, because like we were just mentioning now, it's got jalapenos in there. There's some chili flakes. There's some hint of lemon, coriander, cumin. So I think that's kind of got all your essentials already in that. So you could
and a bit of balance. And I'd even put maybe a bit of sour cream on there. I think it's all about the counterbalance of things. So you want a bit of crunch, you want a bit of soft, you want a bit of heat, you want a bit of, you know?
Yeah, what are we not putting on your nachos? Yo, we know the answer.
I don't know, man. I'm trying to find something. Can we put a steak on top?
You can put a steak on top.
Well, with the quality of this mince, I think we kind of put a steak inside.
But I do
by the looks of it, hey?
Yeah.
Absolutely beautiful. I look forward to the plate that's going to be
brought. We got you, brother. Get that belly ready. Man's looking so shredded at the moment. Kudos to G-Man. Definitely mastering his diet and capitalizing on meals like this and ensuring that it's like a treat. It's like something to look forward to. And that's exactly what's happening right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Mzansi. Nothing but treats, nothing but good times here. It's your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's the Culinary Conundrums. We've got more of these mince masterclasses coming at you. Chef Clem's delivering, so get that belly ready. We got you.
Oh, I don't know what looks better, the nachos or the kitchen.
I'm loving it all. I could live in that kitchen, quite frankly. And it's big enough to put a bed there. We are there for that. Of course, we are all cat people, okay? Some of us in varying degrees of being cat people, but we love it. On a very exciting note now, earlier this month, Whiskers gave one lucky viewer, a cat person, undoubtedly the opportunity to win an entire Whiskers hamper and a personalized portrait of their cat painted by lipstick artist Sarah Britton, who is amazing.
Oh, now to enter, all you had to do was send in a super cute photo of your cat. And this morning, we finally get to reveal our winner. Yeah. Now, without further ado, can we say congratulations to Joan Funamarva, who sent in this adorable photo of her perfect cat, Leo. Oh. Look at Leo taking a little snooze. You are our, in fact, both of you are our lucky winners.
Yeah, I suppose they're both winning, and Joanne, she gets to win every day because she's got little Leo by her side. Absolutely beautiful. Now, for the best part, it's time to reveal the artwork, which has been painted entirely using lipstick by that incredibly talented artist, as I said, Sarah Britton. Take a little gander at this.
Oh, that is a beautiful portrait.
Oh, she captured the sleepy face perfectly.
Oh. I wonder if you get black lipstick, if she can do that for me.
I'm sure she could. In today's world, I have no doubt if someone's going to release a black lipstick just for that.
I mean, she's got white lipstick, so there should be black lipstick.
She can do it, man. She can do it. I love that. I've also got a little Leo in my life, but he's a dog, not a cat. But I love our cats, and I love their personalities more than anything else. And I think she nailed it. She captured their personalities. So, to Joan, we have no doubt that Leo will love his Whiskers hamper, most importantly. And, of course, you're going to love your new artwork. It'll look stunning in your home. Congrats.
And we can't wait for you to receive it. And if you have more pictures of Leo, send it our way.
Keep them coming.
Just look at that, Mzanzo. It's so delicious. We've just finished up our first session of Mint's Masterclasses, and Chef Clem's coming through with another one. Yes, we're going to be diving into the world of pizzas, I believe.
We're going to make a masala mince pizza.
Yes, please. It is getting delicious. Now, of course, with all these macros going into our body, we need to work out and use all this energy. So we're going to bring you another episode of How Tech Can Improve Your Workout. Yes, that and a whole lot more right here. Don't go anywhere.
Join us as we inspire hope across South Africa on Friday, the 27th of October. It's the Hopetober Takeover right here on Expresso. Brought to you by Adcock Ingram OTC, sponsors of Brave. We bring you inspiring guests, messages of hope, and live performances for Mzansi. Plus, you stand a chance of winning 1,500 Rand cash every hour on the show. So mark your calendars and get ready for a morning of hope. Friday, the 27th of October, only on S3.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Oh, yes, Mzansi, welcome back. Your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Let me tell you, I am feeling so good, getting geared up. This masterclass of mints is absolutely delivering right now, and there's so much more coming at you. Yes, the Culinary Hotline bling is not going anywhere, and we are ready to serve you in so many other spheres. For now, though, official duties must commence, and of course, G-Man standing by with the latest.
Thank you so much, Raul. Let's kick it off with our national news first. And in a view of transport strikes and criminal activity at transport facilities in the Western Cape, the City of Cape Town has launched a new safety initiative. So it'll work with the Western Cape government in deploying law enforcement officers at public transport facilities in the city to curb the crime. A great step. Cape Town's Mayor Jordan Hill Lewis launched his first transport security unit in Mitchell's Plain yesterday and said this would contribute to making transport facilities safer for commuters and transport operators. And the deployment will be based on hotspot identification by data analysis from the city's public transport department. A smart city on the way. We love that. Now, of course, in firm focus at the moment, the Independent Electoral Commission, the IEC, officially launched its national and provincial election communication campaign yesterday morning in Midrand. So the chairperson, Mosotho Moyapa, says the fact that independent candidates will participate in the election for the first time, which is quite an exciting time indeed, means that the necessary legal amendments have to be made. And Moyapa is expecting a challenging election in that regard. So the first registration weekend takes place on the 18th and 19th of November, and there are 26.2 million registered voters at the moment. Let's hope we're going to use our voice. Now, we cast a wider gaze on the international news front. The Secretary General of the UN, Antonio Guterres, is extremely concerned about the violation of international humanitarian law in the Gaza Strip right now. In the current critical situation, it's important that basic principles are followed, such as protecting civilians. And he said some 700 Palestinian residents have died in Israeli airstrikes in Gaza on Monday night alone, the highest single-day death toll. Meanwhile, Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has told France's Prime Minister Emmanuel Macron that no one will live under Hamas's tyranny, after the war. Macron added that 30 French citizens were killed in the October 7 attacks in Israel by Hamas. Now, we bring it a little bit closer to home. In Ghana, they have deposited seeds in the Arctic Circle's Doomsday Vault. What is that, you may ask? Well, it's quite interesting. So in an attempt to ensure the long-term protection of the country's major food crops, the Svalbard Global Seed Vault, which is a facility nestled in the Arctic mountain on the remote Norwegian island of Spitsbergen, safeguards some 1.2 million seed samples, the world's largest collection of crop diversity in any single location. It's designed to withstand all natural and possible human disasters. Ethiopia, Kenya, Nigeria, Zambia have all already made deposits in the Doomsday Vault. I hope South Africa is going to jump on board. Now, let's round off with this one. With October obviously being a very important month, being National Breast Cancer Awareness Month, the East London-based Golf Society has joined hands with a clinical pathology services company, Pathcare, to raise funds for assisting breast cancer survivors in the Eastern Cape. So the initiative is part of promoting women's health and also to make treatment accessible to underprivileged communities who have been denied. And Pathcare's Dr. Zipo Mafika said they aim to take the diagnostics to the doorsteps of those who are most vulnerable in the province. Breast cancer is the most common cancer amongst women in South Africa, accounting for 22.6% of all female cancers, in fact. The Golf Society has called on private companies to come aboard and support the cause. You can hear them rallying to our cause right now. This kind of movement, we are behind that. And we love it when sport can be used for good. So let's see the good, the bad, and the ugly of sport right now with Ryle.
Yeah, well, let's start off with the good. Now, working over to the world of rugby right now, and World Rugby has unveiled exciting developments for the Men's Rugby World Cup in 2027. Now, the competition is set to expand from 20 nations to 24, creating more opportunities for teams and regional contests. Now, additionally, a biannual international competition starting in 2026 will feature a top division of 12 teams from the Six Nations and the Rugby Championship, with two additional countries, potentially Japan and Fiji, joining in. Now, matches are scheduled for July and November, promising an exhilarating future for all rugby fans. Well, from the world of rugby, let's head over to the world of cricket. And World Cup is all around. Yes, in a breathtaking World Cup showdown, the Proteas soared to victory with Quinton de Kock's stellar 174 runs and Hendrik Claassen's quick 90-run innings. Now, the Proteas posted a formidable 382 runs for 5 wickets, securing a commanding 149-run win against Bangladesh. Now, Marco Janssen's superb 2-for-39 opened the bowling charge, reducing Bangladesh to 58-for-5, and that with a final dismissal of 233. Now, de Kock, celebrating his 150th cap, displayed extraordinary prowess, amassing 15 fours and 7 sixes in a mere 140 deliveries, showcasing power and finesse. Now, next up for our boys will be Pakistan on Friday, and the New Zealand team taking place on the 1st of November. Well, sticking to cricket news right now, in a strategic move aimed at ensuring players remain committed to international duty amid global T20 league temptations, the England and Wales Cricket Board unveiled revamped central contracts. Now, while most cricketers, such as top-order batsman Joe Root and Harry Brook, along with fast bowler Mark Wood, have committed to 3-year deals running until October 2026, Test captain Ben Stokes, despite his pivotal role in England's Test side and the T20 World Cup victory, has opted for a standard 12-month extension. Now, an additional 15 players have signed on for 2-year contracts, and this shift reflects the evolving landscape of cricket and the measures being taken to retain England's top talent. Well, diving into the world of football, and in a thrilling Champions League clash, Harry Maguire's second-half leader secured a 1-0 victory for Manchester United against FC Copenhagen. Now, goalkeeper Andre Onana's late penalty save further solidified United's win, marking their first victory in the tournament this season. Now, Erik ten Hag's side, back in the competition after a year, now holds third place in Group A, earning 3 crucial points in 3 games. Now, meanwhile, Bayern Munich leads the group with 9 points following a 3-1 victory over Galatasaray. Well, that's all the sporting news we have for you right now. We'll do it all again in the hour. For now, though, let's dive into the world of traffic.
Thank you, Raul. Well, let's start off with traffic in Pretoria. There's congestion on the N4 westbound. It is before Proefplaas Interchange. All lanes are currently open. In Pietermaritzburg, in KwaZulu-Natal, there's a truck broken down on the N3 northbound. It's after Camperdown Interchange, and that left lane is closed. Please drive carefully. Then in Cape Town, there's some congestion on the R300 northbound. It's at the N1 inbound ramp. Expect delays heading into Cape Town this morning. That's your traffic. Let's take another look at your weather. And we start off with some news. The Western Cape is at present basking in the aftermath of a wet and rainy winter season, with average dam levels in the province sitting at a stunning 91%. The Tierwaterskloof Dam, the largest in the region, already reached full capacity some time ago. And thanks to the consistent and substantial rainfall witnessed over the past few months, various other dams in the province are also overflowing. Despite the encouraging state of water resources, the Department of Water and Sanitation is calling for responsible water usage among residents. This will help to ensure that sufficient water continues to be supplied during the hot summer months ahead. Well, on that note, that's where I leave your weather. Let's take a look at your temperatures. Worcester and Upington enjoy those temperatures in the 30s. Well, let's look at your sunrise view for the hour. Carol Curtis from Norwood, Johannesburg, shared her stunning sunrise view with us. And this is what she had to say. She said, a relaxed mood right now. It's so beautiful. There's a slight breeze too. I'm taking it all in. Well, thank you for that, Carol. Share your morning view with us. You can do so on our WhatsApp line. Our number is 063-408-8863.
Don't be shy. Come, man. Come into the kitchen. It's a beautiful, brand-new space. Chef Clem is here. It's a safe place.
It's a safe place.
Is it a safe place when you're making spicy mince pizza?
I can't guarantee.
No, it's going to be very, very spicy. Yes, the culinary hotline continues on the other side of this. We are loving our mince this morning. Whether you rinse it or not, we don't care. But you don't need to anymore. So we've got another delicious recipe coming up on that front. And then, of course, we're using some smart tech to enhance our workouts. Get on board. We'll see you now.
If your cooking makes you proud, then you might be Mzansi's next cooking star. To be a part of Colour Your Plate with Koo on SABC2, show us how a healthier you starts with you and your tasty plate. Take a video of yourself creating a colourful meal and tell us why you should be Mzansi's next cooking star. WhatsApp your entry to 072-741-5357 and you could be on the new season. Plus, stand to win your share of prizes valued at 500,000 Rand. Colour Your Plate with Koo.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back to another installment of the Culinary Hotline. Bling!
Ding, 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 ding.
We are being given a masterclass by Chef Clenno. I'm sorry, I think I've opened every cupboard and every drawer in our beautiful kitchen because there is so much stuff here.
There's Am I allowed to?
I even put a spring onion there for later, just in case, boy, because you never know.
You never know.
How are we going to use 9 pizza slices? In fact, how many pizza slices will we need today?
You're going to need one. I'm going to need one. It's all about the pizza fun.
With great power comes great responsibility. Yes. Thank you for giving me my own miniature pizza.
You're welcome.
Pizzas are great when you can do them yourself. Okay, there is something magical about making your own pizza, and then you can do it your way. Every now and then, I like a mince pizza.
There's just something of when you're going to get it right.
Not every time.
Perfectly seasoned, and then it's just the one. Also, when we talk about the festive season, which is going to be happening, you're going to be cooking a lot, right? Mince is so versatile. I say always just keep mince in the freezer or in the fridge. When it comes to pizza time, just make a spicy mince that pop it on there. Everyone's happy.
I love it. And I like the fact, okay, I don't know what how this made it onto the table, but buddy, it's okay. It's not pepper. So generally people like throw peppers into a spicy pizza and kind of, or mince pizza and take it that way.
Yeah.
I like this flavor profile here. It kind of feels a little bit Italian. I love this,
a little
dude.
Italian, a little Indian.
I'm
you know what?
There
mix
for
it.
That.
Mix
okay,
it.
So let's fuse. This is the ultimate fusion pizza. Let's rock and roll,
I need
baby.
Your help. If I'm you can pop you. Your glove on there, you're going to work with the mince.
Okay.
You can add all of your mince to the... Actually, add half of your mince to the bowl. Okay. And then half of the masala curry paste.
Ooh, this
and
is going
to
be
all
crazy.
All I need to do is to mix it all together, get it really worked in there.
Was that done on purpose, okay? Was I given a gentleman's... No, these have been cut off, man. This is just mean.
Show them.
This is just mean. Look at that. Who can
Who
see that?
Who would cut? Who would cut?
Okay, so let me show you.
Sosies, for all of you. So
that's for whoever. Look at that. Look at those holes there. Thank you, whoever did that. That's actually quite cute. Thank you. Was
that you? It wasn't me. It wasn't me. Okay, so you're going to get your glove that's on. Got, and then you're really going to...
I want to say that's Raul, but that's got Lucian all
got
over
Lucian
it, man. Oh, no, no. I'm just
going
the other. Can we have, like, grown-up size ones? Okay, I'll tell you what. My hands have been sanitized, and I will re-sanitize
your
them after the mince.
Sanitized.
Okay? I really don't mind.
Yeah, that was amazing. I love that. I love that. Okay.
Okay, I'm going to do a double sanitize just to be extra, extra... There we go.
Everybody watches the show and says, you guys are so professional. We love what you guys do on TV.
You're a bunch of children.
Meanwhile, we're
a bunch of children. A bunch of little children. Absolutely love it. Okay, so what am I'm wanting from this mince right now? We obviously want to get the flavor right through, huh?
Yes, sir. So you're going to, if you have time, if you can let that chill for a little bit, marinate for even just about an hour, it'll make such a huge difference. So get that in there. If you don't have time, just make it and give it 5 minutes.
What are you doing with our pizza dough there, Brie? First of all, what kind of dough are you using?
So, Nicole has made a beautiful pizza dough, and if you want to find the recipe, go and check it out on espressoshow.com. What she did, which is what I love, is letting the dough rest. You end up with so much more flavor just by letting your dough rest.
Just let it develop. So I'm going to nick a spoon here
you
from one of our amazing drawers. There we go. Come to me, my friend. A wooden spoon is what I'm waiting for.
We are loving the fact
there
that
we go. There is always a way. So I'm looking at this masala paste. Curry leaves, chili, onions, and tomatoes. They've done it all for you. And it looks like these flavors have been developed. I'm looking at a funkiness in this oil that would only come after a long cook, after getting those flavors rendered out.
Exactly.
Is it all going in?
It is. Do you think we should do, like, in the theme of rugby, we should do, like, a rugby ball-shaped pizza?
Please do.
Like, literally just, I feel
my
like
my life would not be complete without a rugby ball-shaped pizza. Please do that right now.
Oh, yeah, okay, we're happening. That's my pizza-shaped pasta. I mean, pizza-shaped... rugby ball-shaped pizza dough. Because I can't speak, maybe you should listen to a voice note from Shireen.
Please. She actually put this comment through. Take a look at this. This is what Shireen had to say. And, of course, we are going to take a little squiz there at Shireen's culinary question. And she was asking, good morning, Clem and team. Happy Wednesday. Loving the culinary hotline this morning, especially as you're making mince dishes. Thanks for all the recipes this morning. Clem, it looks delicious. And I appreciate all the tips on what you can make with mince. It's so versatile and budget-friendly. Have a super day, family. Well, right back at you, sister. Thank you so much for being so connected to the culinary hotline. Trust me, everything I know about good meat and how to treat it, I've learned from Clem.
Well, 90%. That's so kind.
No, it's not, dude. And I love the fact that we are now treating our mince like we would treat our steaks.
Yes.
A beautiful piece of meat who deserves the respect. This is looking great, dude. Mm.
There we go. There we go.
The flour, is it an absolute necessity?
Oh, yes. The flour mixed with the semolina flour. So the flim is...
Semolina, yeah.
Guys, my English is done for the year. For the year.
You're not alone, Boyki. You're
the
not alone.
Semolina acts almost like ball bearings between the pizza dough and the pizza paddle, right? So it just kind of keeps on sliding, which means it's not going to get stuck on the paddle or inside your uni.
There we go. And you want to do this quite quickly because that uni don't play.
No,
okay? That uni
it doesn't.
Don't play at all. It's very hot in there. Poor Nicole just about did like a dive double backflip to stop me putting my hand in there to see if it was. So thank you, Nicole, for saving my hand in the process. It gets very hot. But look at that.
There we go.
We've got enough mints to make about 30 pizzas, I'm realizing.
Because you don't need a lot. Yeah, that's what I love about this, especially when you're making pizzas. You don't need a lot. You've packed in so much flavor in there. The flavor's concentrated, so you don't need a lot. A little bit does its job in there. Oh, it's happening. Amazing. It's happening. It's smelling amazing. And honestly, can I just say, I'm obsessed with the uni. I've been using it so much. I just used it yesterday for Taste Magazine.
Oh, really?
Pedro's Pizza Party is happening. I'm telling you.
Is it happening on Saturday night when the rugby is happening?
It's happening.
Okay.
Wednesday night, Thursday night, Friday night.
Because you've got to test, you've got to put it through its paces. But this does kind of speak to the social time of the year. Pizza is great. And if you can make your own and you can have a whole lot of different variations, I mean, this is starting to look like it's come straight from Napoli, man.
There we go.
And I like this vibe. This is for me. The pizza vibe that I like.
Yes.
You know, people are all thin-based, thick-based. No, in between. It must be like that.
And also,
rustic and awesome.
According to your mood, sometimes you're feeling like you want thin crust, but sometimes you want a nice little puffy crust on there. This one's quite nice. And the puffy crust, especially if it's a smaller sized pizza, make it with a little thicker crust. That's the thing, though. So then you're still feeling satisfied.
Completely. But you need a bit more to handle what you've got on the in terms of the topping. So if you're going with a light topping, maybe just a little bit of mozzarella, tomato, a bit of basil, great. Thin, crispy, lovely. If you've got a bit of substance in your sauce, come on. Give it something that's going to hold it, that's going to keep its backbone.
Oh, look at that nice chart. Okay, we literally have 15 seconds in record time.
Wow.
Okay, 15 seconds. Let's talk about the toppings we're going to go with today. I'm gonna do this for you. I'm not gonna put the coriander on.
Oh no, you can, but you can with absolute pleasure.
We're gonna do crispy onions. Off,
but I don't want to deny people that flavor combination because I would imagine with this gorgeous masala that's been developed so beautifully by the Woolies food development team, absolutely. Oh
yeah, that's you. You gotta grill. Whop it.
Great power.
Take it out for me. Here we go. There we go. Do you gotta do it with confidence? Do it with confidence. Ah.
Hello, my friend.
Look at that.
Oh, I see what you mean about the char. That's
I never
beautiful.
Get over how quickly it makes these pizzas. Ryle de Mornay, this is quite a protein-packed pizza. So you've been here before for...
Did someone say pizza?
Pizza.
Did someone say pizza? That's all I needed to hear. Gents, it is looking
good. There's mint, there's curry. It is wonderful.
And I like how you didn't burn it this time. So we learned from our first session. Why are you going to bring this shape?
I was a different person then. I was different then.
Gents, what is
he's
on
changed.
Your...
He's,
what's
he's
on gonna, your
well, you're going to help us finish it off, dude.
Yeah, okay, let's do this.
So beautiful tomato sauce. We've got some mozzarella, spicy masala mint. All I need you to do, hit it with a little bit of spring onion, a little bit of coriander.
Cut up already. Hang on, let me just...
There we go.
Buddy, I know we've had to do our taste test challenges and you've gone the two-times spicy noodles about 9 times and I've had to eat my coriander and we've had to do it. But how do you feel about this flavor profile, the curry mince coriander on a pizza vibe? I think this is really exciting.
So I'll be honest with you, first reaction was a no. Like, why are you mixing these things together? This is like a stewy curry meal and a pizza. Like, they don't vibe. But, like, the fact that Chef Clem's putting it together and he's got this big smile on his face, I'm already buying into it without even tasting it.
We were talking about curry sloppy joes yesterday, a bit of a leftover curry.
That'll be the most bougie
sloppy joe that ever sloppied, okay?
What else can I pop on you?
Crispy onions and a little bit of coriander maybe on the one side.
Have you found something that you can't put the crispy onions or the chili crunch on yet?
Ice cream. I honestly believe if you have decadent vanilla ice cream, the crispy onions would do something, and it would be a good something.
The chili flakes would probably do it as well.
The chili oil, yes. Okay, so now we got to do is we got to slice it up.
I see, G-Man, I got your side there. I got you all sorted. Don't worry.
Thank you so much, my boy. You don't understand. So this is one of the things. When I am fasting, obviously, you crave, like, the calorie bombs. I don't know if you've gone through that, but you want full value for every bite that you're having. Thank you so much.
It's hot. It's so hot.
This right here is the kind of cheers I would always love to do with my lads. So, ladies and gentlemen, cheers to you, Chef Clem. Thanks for coming through. Cheers.
I'm going to say
cheers
to all those who are breaking a fast this morning.
Cheers. All of those breaking a fast this morning.
48 hours.
48 hours. Ain't no joke, bro. Oh, I love you so much.
Zoe will save you a piece. Promise.
Okay, I take everything back. I said, this kind of thing on a pizza... It works. I've got to go back to duties, but I'm going to take this with me.
I'm going to commend both you and Nicole, the body on the pizza base. This base is insane. Just put your smiley face in quickly and just wave with appreciation because you're amazing. This is Nicole who does everything.
Come here for Nicole!
Come on, Nicole! Woo! This is exquisite, girl. Absolutely exquisite.
Wow.
So here's the deal. If you want to share a meal with friends, if you want to entertain, a pizza gives you so many different directions to put. But the mince elevates it to a proper meal status. If you want this, head over to espressoshow.com. Absolutely amazing. I'm going to enjoy my second bite probably more than my first. This is exquisite. You've smashed it, dude. Mm.
It looks amazing. How was the pizza?
It tastes so good. I'm now officially hungry. I'm going to finish the rest of it as soon as we're done here. That was so good. Thanks for coming through, Chef Clem. I love that one.
Well, listen, Vodacom is making it easier and more affordable than ever to access the latest wearables like smartwatches and buds when you enhance your plan with smart tech. Now, we absolutely love this because smartwatches don't just transform how you work out, but how you live too. Now, you can track your workouts, but also leave your phone at home and still take calls, pay for things, and even listen to music. I have not jumped on that bandwagon just yet.
Yeah, so I've been using the smartwatch for a lot of things, right? So I use it obviously for training, tracking my calls. I've been very big on sleep as well. It's like a superpower at the moment, so I've been trying to capitalize and maximize my sleep. But one thing I don't have is the ability to make calls. So I unfortunately still have to bring my phone with me, but I'm thinking that's something I would love to do, like especially just to be a little bit more free on a run, not having that big phone in your like pocket or whatever when you have that like sort of like desire to just like escape. I think that's where I need to step my game up when it comes to smartwatches. Yeah, definitely.
For myself as well. I mean, when you do a workout, you always try and, you know, safety first, especially if you're doing an outdoor workout. So having that giant phone on your arm, you become a target, especially being a woman as well. So I haven't jumped on that bandwagon just yet, but I love the smartwatch. I love that I get to, you know, track my workout, see how many calories I've burned. But also when you're in a meeting, you can just quickly check, okay, the message came through, it's not urgent, it can wait.
100%, that keeps you so, so connected. I know for me, I need to be connected to my fuel and my diet. So on average, I have to like eat about 3,500 calories a day. Why? Because when I look at my watch at the end of the day, that's how many calories I've burnt. Putting in one, maybe two workouts a day and moving a lot, that's a lot of calories. I don't have it tracked right now on my watch to show you. I've just got the watch mode on so I can stick to work and not get distracted. But otherwise, literally, I get so consumed that I'm like, ooh, I've still got this many calories. And I'm like, it's really keeping me plugged in, keeping me accountable at the same time, and really, truly allows me to just smash my goals without really worrying about, I wonder if, or did I do this? No, I've got it all like on this dashboard right on my wrist, which is really amazing.
And what I love, especially when you're watching a movie or something, my smartwatch every now and then will remind me, like, you've been sitting for a while, it's time to stand up. I've been sitting for a while.
I've seen a lot of kids, especially today, actually not just kids, but everybody commuting, doing public transport, they're actually using their watch to listen to music as well. So using wireless buds or something like that, or earphones, and connecting straight to your watch without having your cell phone on you, that is also so cool. Again, I'm thinking of how you could just run, how you could get focused at work, not get distracted by a device or need to carry it around when doing that. I mean, that's pretty cool, right? Yeah,
that
I love it.
Pretty cool. Well, we've asked you online, how is a smartwatch, how would it enhance your life? And this is what everyone had to say. So let's take a look. Cynthia says, pay for things without a wallet. Track my workouts. Yes, you can do smart pay.
I forgot about that as well, because I've just figured that out on my phone and using it and realizing the convenience. You can do it on your watch. Amazing. All right, comments keep coming through. Let's see who else is out in the building. Patricia Keegan says, to track my workouts, definitely. Yes, please. Keeping you healthy, keeping you in check. And Gwenya says, take calls on the go. I need to jump on that bandwagon. I see a lot of people doing
that. It's very convenient when your phone's somewhere in the house and you're like, oh, I can't get to it, but then you can just answer it on the watch. Leanne says, take calls on the go, pay for things without a wallet. And it's so clever if you're driving. It's an alternative to being hands-free because you don't have to talk like this.
Yes.
It can hear you where it's still at a distance and your hands stay on the steering wheel.
I feel like look down at your device. That's dangerous first. You don't ever use your phone while you're driving. But that is a quick little sneaky, okay, cool, I've got it.
And you can talk and hear and everything, and it's a good distance.
I need to upgrade now after that officially. But I think with Vodacom, you can pick and choose from the latest range of smartwatches and buds when you enhance your plan. And the best part, with their eSIM solution, you can seamlessly connect your devices so that you'll never miss a notification and even be able to listen to music and make payments when you're on the go.
Oh, it's not just about enhancing your plan, but about enhancing your life. And to view all the trendy wearables on offer, you can visit voda.com/enhance.
All right, let's find that upgrade now. Let's go. Where are you?
Mzansi, enhance what you love. Add more of what you need to your contract. Choose from a range of enhanced options in-store or online. Further together, Vodacom.
Oh, talk about entertainment powerhouse. Warming up behind me, three incredible dancers from the Mzansi Ballet. The Queen Show is coming to your feel-good stage in just a moment. We cannot wait for that. These guys are just incredible. And when we talk about entertainment powerhouses, say hello to my good friend, Carol. We're going to be talking about Miss World South Africa, an incredible opportunity to delve into the world of pageantry and what we can achieve. And of course, our CEO, Carol Bauer, is going to be chatting to me. One of my oldest friends in the industry. Cannot wait to reconnect with her. Stick around. Welcome back. You can see how excited I am right now. Yes, I get to connect with an old friend within the industry, but someone who is doing so much for as many people as she can, and she's doing it with a very powerful tool. Pageantry is not only about beautiful faces, an elegant stride, lucrative, amazing prizes. It's most importantly about empowering young women with poise, with grace, with invaluable life skills like self-discipline, self-confidence, motivation, worldliness, which I think is more important than anything right now, and that determination to become a generation of well-versed women who South Africa can be proud of. This is an empowerment platform. That is the mission of Miss World South Africa, an event looking to find the right woman to send to the Miss World Finals in December. And celebrated media personality and businesswoman and just wonderful human being, Carol Bauer, now connects with us. Thank you so much for joining us, my friend. Always good to see you. At some point, I'm hoping you're going to age and stop looking like a Miss World winner from last year. I've got to ask, how are you? I know it's a crazy year, so much going on in our different spaces. How is your space looking right now, and how are you?
It's manic, Graham. And I think that, you know, the joy that I derive from doing these interviews is the fact that I get to connect with people I love, such as yourself. Thank you so much for this opportunity. It's been the most empowering journey. There have been a lot of challenges. As you know, I don't come from the pageant world.
Yeah.
So being immersed, and having to drive it and having to ensure that the girls have the confidence that we are going to deliver to them the right pathway to global impact has just been, it's grown me more than what it's done for them, I believe.
Yeah, as a mentor and a teacher, that's when you really do learn, I think, because you have to, because you've got the added responsibility of having these young people in your channel and you're going to guide them. I know you're going to be amazing because you've always been a mentor. I think even the first time we met, although there was very little age difference at the time, you mentored me through one of my first big opportunities, which was wonderful. So thank you for being that within the industry. I do come from the world of pageantry, believe it or not, because I've hosted probably more Miss South Africa's and Miss SA Teens and competitions like that. So I've seen firsthand what a platform like Miss World South Africa can do for young women. But what was your drive to get into this? Why use this vehicle?
Do you know, I think that when I accepted it, Graham, it was purely a business decision. It was something that would allow me to take the business into a different trajectory. We've been trying to grow the business globally, and it would allow me to have a global footprint as part of a network of owners of the Miss World license internationally. But I think in going through the motions and learning about it and realizing that this is actually essentially an NGO. This is a platform to build communities, to go into different spaces and ensure that we leave impact. We leave them inspired by beautiful girls who, you know, represent their provinces. But what we do essentially is that we transform that space and make it better than what we found it. And I think, you know, you will know even when we first met and we're working on that incredible project that took us, put us on billboards around South Africa, you'll know that I'm a shy person, so pageantry is not something that I would have even considered, but I am so deeply, deeply honored to be able to take women from the most rural of surrounds, women from the most urban of surrounds, and give them an ability to have equality, to have a sort of democratic pathway to global fame.
It's not fame for the sake of, it's fame that is backed up with gravitas. I'm going to look at this in two ways, from a strategic network, and that's something you do understand as one of our kind of most prominent businesswomen in your space. You understand the power of having mentors, of having older female businesswomen to plug into. That's a massive thing, and that comes with this kind of side of the pageantry. But this is the Miss World title. Come on, does it get bigger than that? How coveted is this title? Now that you know, how big is this potential end result?
It is the most coveted beauty title in the world. It's the oldest, it's the most prestigious, and as I said, it intimidates me even more. In 2 days' time, we will all be at the airport welcoming Miss World to South Africa, because she will be coming to do the crowning for us. In addition to that, we'll be welcoming the owners of the Miss World pageant. And if you look at the fact that this is a platform that has raised over £1 billion internationally for charitable work, I realize the responsibility on our shoulders. It's glamorous, it's beautiful, but it is important. It transforms spaces, it transforms lives, and we're going to be taking one young lady and making sure that she wins the Miss World title after she's won Miss World South Africa. But what we're going to do also is to ensure that she leaves an indelible mark on the world. I've been working with the UN network for many, many years, and we've in our small ways tried to contribute to global impact, whether it's from femicide, ending GBV, making sure that there's access to education for all. But I think that this is one platform that touches every life, and I'm just so excited to be a part of it. 140 around the world owners of this license. I feel that there is a lot for me to learn from the other 139, and I'm glad that South Africa is behind us. We have everyone looking forward to being with us on Saturday evening. Beyond the crowning, of course, we will be taking the biggest crown in sport in France, making sure that, you know, we celebrate the Bocuse and we celebrate the Miss World South Africa winner. So I'm excited to create also a beautiful lounge for everyone who's going to be a part of us to come out and enjoy the Bocuse as well. Everything that we're doing as a business is geared towards making sure that South Africa is better, South Africa is united, and we don't talk cohesion, but we live social cohesion every day.
Completely. I mean, the world, as polarized as it is, needs that voice more now than ever. But I'll tell you, from my bird's eye view of this industry at my ripe old age, I'll tell you the one thing that matters more than anything else is for young black girls to see this, to see you doing what you're doing right now, to see these winners pushing, to see members of their community stepping onto this powerful stage of empowerment, and the fact that we can see it on free-to-air, that it's going to be carried by the SABC. It just feels like the stars are aligning right through to that Rugby World Cup final. So thank you for being this voice always, and for being just so lovely. Thank you for being that example to so many other South Africans. I think we owe you a debt of gratitude, my friend. Thank you so much.
Thank you. I love you so much, Graham. Thank you for this platform. See you all at the State Theatre at 4:00. Hit that red carpet looking amazing. Welcome all. Lots of love.
Oh, no pressure. You better look amazing if you're going to hit that red carpet. And, of course, you can catch it live right here on S3. This is a massive opportunity for the girls that are involved, but also for South Africa and our entertainment industry. This puts us on the global map.
Oh, and speaking of the global map, Mzansi Ballet, they are on your Feel Good Breakfast show today with a brand new show called The Queen Show. And we've got some of the dancers here to unpack a little bit more what this is all about. Because they're taking the Espresso stage this morning, and these dancers are from the Johannesburg-based Mzansi Ballet. We have Joshua, Javier, as well as Mahlatse joining us today. Now, Javier, I'm going to start off with you. How long have you been with Mzansi Ballet, and what is Mzansi Ballet all about?
So I've been with Mzansi Ballet since 2011, so almost 10 years. So yeah, Mzansi Ballet is a company, ballet company based in Johannesburg, where we have international dancers as well, from South Africa, from Cuba, China, Spain. Yeah, we do most of the classical ballet and contemporary, and it's an amazing company.
Oh, it sounds amazing. And I mean, we heard the sound check. You're playing us all our favorite songs from Queen.
Yeah.
Now, that is what the Queen Show is all about. You don't necessarily think ballet with the music of Queen. You think rock, you think contemporary. But what is the Queen Show all about?
So the Queen Show is about having fun. And we have all the choreography by Angela Riwi and Michael Riwi. So we basically do choreography with Queen song, and which is amazing. What the audience can expect is like fun, excitement, and fully of amazing choreography.
And even if you don't know ballet, you know the music and you get to appreciate the art of ballet even more. Now, Mahlatse, I'm going to ask you, what is something that you are looking forward to being not only part of Mzansi Ballet, but also this production?
What I'm looking for being part of Mzansi Ballet in this production is to get a chance to experience dancing on stage again, you know? And because Mzansi Ballet does a variety of different art forms with regards to dance, it gives you an opportunity to not just do ballet, but to also do modern works, do contemporary, do music that normally people don't use. Because in the classical work, you use music like Bach, music from the olden days, you know? Whereas now with more modern works, you use music from Queen's work. And then with that, you know, people can also have a way of like singing along every now and then.
Oh, well, listen, I'm waiting for you to bring out a Taylor Swift, Swifties ballet production.
You never know.
Well, we're going to focus on Queen, the Queen Show, and we have the performers here today from the Mzansi Ballet. I'll take that microphone from you, and the floor is yours.
I want it all. Just an alley creeper, light on his feet. A young fighter screaming, with no time for doubt. With the pain and anger, can't see a way out. It ain't much I'm asking, I heard him say. Gotta find me a future, move out of my way. I want it all. Here's to the future for the dreams of you. Hey.
your feel-good breakfast show. That was incredible. I'm getting so excited for the rest of the day. Well, listen, make sure you visit. And of course, you can get your tickets. Those details are on your screen right now. The Queen Show, that production is on. And of course, we have them hanging out with us throughout the morning. So stay tuned to your feel-good breakfast show.
Okay, yeah. Just to compound my, that was amazing. Like the level of athleticism is just mind blowing. Yeah, when you know when Nature Boy is like,
what? Yeah, I got new goals for sure, man. 100%.
Incredible stuff. So I don't know why they keep doing this to me, but I'm gonna have to pick up another All Black. Now we're gonna talk about one of the greatest, really. He is a living goat, Sam Whitelock. We're gonna do a bit of a player profile of a man that I think has a huge leadership role, but also a practical role within that team to kind of answer a little Betsy when we get onto that field. So the lock's really important. We'll get into his journey after this.
A little Betsy. I love that, man. Sham Whitelock coming at you after this, but also we're going to be diving into more of our mince masterclasses and finding out the difference between our mince. Yes, there's quality, more quality, and even more quality. So we're going to dive into that and a whole lot more right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. Don't go anywhere.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Oh, yes, I'm Zanzi. Welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show. And what a show it's been already. And let's elevate it and keep it going, because Woolworths believes in only consistent quality. And that's when it comes to their beef mince. We've been diving into it right now, but let's find out more. Now, they only use selected cuts and never scraps, with only guaranteed fat percentages that they can prove. So someone here to tell us more about the only mince to choose is Woolworths beef mince product developer, Anda Dlepu, in the building. Anda, how are you doing this morning, bro? Oh, fantastic, man. Great. Already we've been diving into this journey of mince. We've seen Chef Clem go out and actually go to where they are preparing this. Oh, I was well impressed, man. I was a bit nervous at first. I was thinking all these like scary stories you hear, and I'm like, oh, are we gonna see this? It was such a breath of fresh air to see how much magic's going into this. Yes. The quality is being assured. But talk to me about exactly what's going on here with Woolies mince at the moment, because it really is quality, right?
It is, absolutely, absolutely. So, I mean, I'll talk just about the difference with the difference with our mince.
Yes.
So the big difference, I mean, if you remember a few weeks back, we actually did steaks with Clement. We chatted about tenderometer, the science in getting steaks to be very tender. Here, again, once again, we're using science again to guarantee the fat that we are adding into our mince. We're using what is called the FOSS machine, which we can guarantee on our extra lean mince to be guaranteed maximum of 5% fat, and also then on our lean mince to guarantee that maximum of 10% fat. Over and above that, you did talk that we do use selected cuts. Absolutely, we use selected cuts, which we then ourselves trim. We'll take off the sinew, any gristle, any bone, before we put the cuts then into a machine, which then over and above the test that we've done to trim all the sinew and all, The machine has also got a gristle extractor and sinew extractor. Whoa. So whatever the eye misses, the machine will then catch. So
doubling that sort of filter for quality right there. I absolutely love that, man. And the fact that, like I was saying to Chef Clem earlier, I literally cooked with the lean mince yesterday. It is so incredible when you're working on your health and your diet and looking for these ultimate sort of options. Yes. The mince is really so versatile. There's so much you can do with it. The fact that you know how much protein you're getting in, how much fat, your macros are sorted out. And there's options, right? And it's not just the beef we're talking about. Take me through the entire range because mince has elevated itself for now. It's like definitely what Woolies has brought through. So tell me about this, man.
So I mean, we know mince, I mean, as beef mince only. Over and above beef mince, we've got what is unique to us, which is purebred Angus, which we've also got in steaks, which is unique and exclusive to Woolies. In mince as well, then we've got Angus mince. Also beef, but it's just a different breed of beef that we are using.
So maybe before you tell me about the entire range, let's just touch on this quickly before we move on.
Absolutely.
What is the difference between, let's say, Angus beef and your normal beef? I mean, obviously, they both taste incredible to me. I love the normal mince that we are getting from our, the normal beef mince, sorry. What's the difference between that and your Angus mince?
Yeah, so as I said, so Angus itself is a pure bred. It's only bred with Angus. It's one unique breed.
Okay.
Similar to Wagyu, you know, if you're going to call in something Wagyu, it's got to be pure bred Wagyu. Here we'll use different breeds or whatever to cross in order to get to that, which doesn't mean that it's not a superior product. It's still great, but what is unique to us and exclusive to us is the Angus that you're talking about.
I love that because I think, like you said, it's not a quality difference, but it's a choice difference when it comes to how you're preparing your meal, what you're preparing as well. Absolutely. So are you making burgers versus, let's say, nachos? That really makes a difference in your choices, and I love that we have these options.
Yes.
You also mentioned it's not just beef mince that you've got,
just
beef mince. What else you got?
It's not just beef mince. So we do have mince and also in other species. So you look at lamb, we've got free-range lamb mince. Ostrich, we've also got ostrich mince on our side as well.
Okay.
And then also on the venison side, we've also got venison mince on our side.
Wow,
so
there's
a whole range within different species. We've got chicken mince then as well. So you look at our total basket, we don't just offer beef, we offer all the other species as well.
That is incredible, man, because obviously I've been venturing towards like some of the ostrich, right? Because I know that's coming with that lean sort of guarantee.
Absolutely.
But I haven't had it as much knowing that I've got the guarantee now based on the fact that you're proving how much fat is in this.
Absolutely.
You've also got chicken mince, which I haven't actually dived into a lot. So I'm sure we're going to be doing a lot more recipes right here on your Feel Good Breakfast show. But man, I didn't even know about this lamb as well.
Yes, there is
like
lamb.
Like what? Okay, it's not stopping there because on top of all the quality that we're talking about right now, on top of the options that we have and the versatility, let me just say in terms of what we can do with mince, there's also this guarantee of a lower price. Now, I've never seen this orange sticker before. I'm used to the red one. What's going on here, bro?
So new lower price, something that we're currently running within our mince or just on lean and extra lean on the 1 kilogram and also the 500 gram. Also, we're doing it then on Angus. So what that is, it's an everyday lower price which we're giving to the customer for an extended period. So meaning that our mince will be on a new lower price for an extended period.
Are you sure, like, this is going on live TV? You sure wanted to see these prices? Is this correct?
Those prices should be correct.
Are you sure, bro? That's like way too cheap,
these are from stores.
Man.
They're from stores. So
and this is a kg pack we're talking about right here. I know, like, I chow down thick. Talking about 3,500 calories on average a day. So for me, this even lasts more than one meal. I mean,
absolutely.
I split this up, I make a lot of it, and like between myself and my partner, we can share this over 2-3 days.
Absolutely.
And we normally eat for a family of four. So that's saying a lot about not only the quality, not only the price, but the fact that this can go so far.
Yeah, absolutely. We also do offer mince then also in our butcher counters that we've got as well. We've got butcher counters across the country in Western Cape and Gauteng. So we do offer the mince. It's also coming in at the new lower price as well. So if you do happen to be in any of those stores, do grab our mince within the butcher counters if you can't get them on the shelf.
And thank you. You are like answering all our prayers right now. South Africa's celebrating this because right now prices have increased, inflation is here, and this is exactly what we want and we came for. So sorting us out, giving us every reason to get involved in this, and of course, Mzansi, shop this right at Woolworths. You can get it in-store, online, and on the app. And what are you waiting for? You can get creative. We've showed you how many incredible meals you can make with this one, and it's not stopping there. More inspiration coming at you on your Feel Good Breakfast show. Anda, that was beautiful, man.
Great.
Thank you.
Thanks, man.
I love it. Let's celebrate.
Well, hopefully we're giving you all the meal inspo you need as you plan your menu for the festive season, because guess what? There are only 60 days to go until Christmas. So this morning on our Feel Good Breakfast show, we asked you in our Good Morning Post to share with us, you know, how excited you are about it. And we've got some voice notes that we received, but we will be unpacking those for you a little bit later. So stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast show. We'll be right back.
To the brave hearts who persevere against all odds, we salute you. Along with Adcock Ingram OTC, sponsors of Brave, we're inspiring hope across South Africa this Hopetober. Stand a chance to win 1,500 Rand cash every weekday by answering the weekly Hopetober competition question on Expresso's Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram pages throughout the month of October using hashtag Hopetober and hashtag sponsors of Brave. T's and C's can be found on ExpressoShow.com. It's my feel good.
Welcome back. Get ready to see your favorite rugby players in action in this weekend's final, the final to beat all finals. But to get to know our contenders a bit better, we're giving you the 411 on one of New Zealand's, probably their greatest player ever, participating obviously in the 2023 Rugby World Cup final, their most capped. And of course, this entire spectacle brought to you by, I would imagine, very proud sponsors of the Total Energies team. They are amazing and they have brought us the best World Cup, I think, ever in history.
We're gonna
focus on the enemy today a little bit because they deserve our respect. He is the most capped All Black player of all time, second behind the great Alanwyn Jones, obviously.
So is it official? Is he the most?
He's the second most capped player of all time. Okay. Samuel Whitelock is a superstar. He's a New Zealand rugby player, obviously born in Palmerston North on the 12th of October back in 1988. Now we're starting to mention dates that I can relate to.
I was born,
yeah. He spent his junior years playing school rugby for the school's first 15, understandably, and then he assumes the position of lock and is known for his physicality, his work ethic, his athleticism, especially at his age. People say he still sets the bar within that All Blacks team, and of course his leadership is not lost.
100%, and the way he moves all that weight is just absolutely incredible. Look at him even taking a kick for the foul's cover. What can't he do?
Just mind games, it's just games.
But listen, Sam began his early rugby career for Canterbury and was called up to Baby All Blacks for the 2008 IRB World Junior Championships. Now, Whitelock skyrocketed into his professional career in 2010 when he made his first appearance for the All Blacks squad in the Rugby Midterm Test Series, where he scored 2 tries in his debut game and completed a successful season in Super Rugby with the Crusaders. Yes, the mighty ones.
Yeah, look, the fact that he's always looked old. He started off with that beard, and he's
become
just
timeless.
But we forget how much of a running back he was as well. It's such a ranging, those long legs through those levers, he can move them. So Sam's longevity for the Crusaders, the most successful team in Super Rugby, spans over a decade, 2010 to 2023. That's incredible. Outstanding performance earned him 2 New Zealand Rugby Awards in 2017, 1 for Super Rugby Player of the Year, and 2 for Best New Zealand Player of the Year. And that was amongst an incredible team. His peers at that stage of their journey, just equally amazing. And then his international contribution to the All Blacks side makes Sam the most capped player in All Black history.
Whoa.
152 tests. That's insane. He surpassed Richie McCaw during this World Cup, and his 4th World Cup at that, in the 2023 campaign. Sam will remain in France after the World Cup as well, as he continues his position as lock for Section Paloas. And he is regarded as undoubtedly one of the best rugby players of his generation. And we are very excited to see what is going to happen when the immortal takes to the field against his old foe. I think these All Blacks want this final matchup with the Boks as much as we do.
Yeah,
I think 100%. They want to prove this against us.
I think they have a lot to prove, especially after our last game with him. So they've got revenge on their lips. I think right now, though, we can see that this is a matchup of note. It's like when an unstoppable force meets an immovable object. Springboks versus the All Blacks. Itzebeth versus Whitelock.
I thought you were talking about Fuff there for sure, man.
It doesn't get any better than this, man, honestly. And this is the reason why I think you have players like this with such incredible manifestos that have come through so many incredible eras, culminating in this moment.
Yeah.
Oh, come on,
bro. We could not have written it better. So get ready for the game. You're going to need to have it all prepped and lined up. We want the festivities to flow. So get your Total Energies on game day, and you can get everything you need. You can top up on your fuel, obviously. You can get your Bright Chocolate, your Firelighters, your snacks, and then more snacks if someone has to pop out to get more snacks because you're nervous eating and nervous drinking all your drinks. And then in the process, you can earn those club points back that can be redeemed as actual cash back. And that, I think, has got everybody interested at the moment. Everyone is feeling the pinch right now. So any little reprieve, we'll take it. But on game day, go and spoil yourself.
Just like in rugby, it's uniting our energies that helps us move forward.
Well, time has just before 8 o'clock. Let's take a final look at your national headlines. Local news, the CEO of NSFAS, the National Student Aid Scheme, Andile Nongogo, has been sacked. This follows the Special Investigation Unit, the SIU's, findings that Nongogo improperly interfered in the awarding of some 47 billion rand tenders to service providers. The chairperson of the NSFAS's board, Ernest Corsa, said Nongogo's contract was terminated because of a breach of trust. Meanwhile, the SIU is currently working to recover some 5.1 billion rand from at least 44,000 students at various tertiary institutions who did not qualify for student aid. And staying with our local news, in view of transport strikes and criminal activity at transport facilities in the Western Cape, the City of Cape Town has launched new safety initiatives. It will work with the Western Cape government in deploying law enforcement officers at public transport facilities in the city to curb crime. Cape Town's Mayor Jordan Hill Lewis launched the first transport security unit in Mitchell's Plain yesterday and said this contributes to making transport facilities safer for commuters and transport operators. The deployment will be based on hotspots identification by data analysts from the city's public transport department. And moving to news abroad, a runoff election will be held next month in Liberia following a photo finish between President George Weah and his rival Joseph Boakai. Weah garnered 43.83% of the vote and Boakai, a former vice president, 43.44%. The 10 October poll was the tightest presidential contest in Liberia since a civil war ended some 2 decades ago. A second round of voting is now necessary as neither candidate received more than 50% of the vote in the first round. It's due to take place on the 14th of November. And staying with news abroad, the Security General of the UN, Antonio Guterres, is extremely concerned about the violation of international humanitarian law in the Gaza Strip. In the current critical situation, it's important that basic principles are followed, such as protecting civilians, he said. Some 700 Palestinian residents died in Israeli airstrikes in Gaza on Monday night, the highest single-day death toll. Meanwhile, Israel's PM, Benjamin Netanyahu, has told France's PM, Emmanuel Macron, that no one will live under Hamas's tyranny after the war. Macron said 30 French citizens were killed in the October 7th attacks in Israel by Hamas. And we are saddened to bring our viewers the news that the Guinness World Record holder Bobby, a thoroughbred dog, has passed away at his home in Portugal, aged 31 years and 165 days. As we reported some time ago, Bobby became both the world's oldest living dog and the oldest dog ever in February, bettering an almost century-old record for the latter title. The secret to Bobby's longevity was said to lie in the peaceful environment he lived in with the Costa family in a village on Portugal's west coast. Announcing his death, the vet said, despite outliving every dog in history, his 11,478 days on earth would never be enough for those who loved him. Well, on that very sad note, that's where we leave your morning headlines. Let's take a final look at your sport.
On that emotional note, let's kick off with some rather exciting news. Temper those emotions just a little bit, as World Rugby has unveiled some great new developments for the Men's Rugby World Cup in 2027. So the competition now is set to expand from 20 nations to 24, creating more opportunities for teams and regional contests. I think in the build-up to that, let's widen the circle. Additionally, a biannual international competition starting in 2026 will feature a top division of 12 teams from the Six Nations and the Rugby Championship. We're thinking of merging the hemispheres with two additional countries, potentially Japan and Fiji, both putting their hands up, hopefully joining in. So matches scheduled for July and November, promising an exhilarating future for rugby fans. And I think the support structures building into that top tier. Now let's turn to the cricketing action that played out yesterday. Astounding in a breathtaking World Cup showdown, the Proteas soared to new heights and to victory with Quinton de Kock. Next up for the boys, two tough draws. We got Pakistan on Friday and then New Zealand on the 1st of November. Now let's take a wider gaze in the cricketing world and look what's maybe a possible pushback to the surge of T20 and the big money therein. In a strategic move aimed at ensuring players remain committed to international duty amid this global T20 league temptation and the money there, the England and Wales Cricket Board have unveiled some revamped central contracts. So while most cricketers, such as top order batsman Joe Root and Harry Brook, are on board, along with fast bowler Mark Wood, they've committed to three-year deals running up until October of 2026. Test captain Ben Stokes, being a pivotal role in England's Test side and their T20 World Cup victory, he's now opted for a standard 12-month extension. And an additional 15 players have all signed on for those two-year contracts. The shift reflects, I think, an evolving landscape of cricket and the measures being taken to retain England's top talent, obviously not performing at their best at the World Cup right now. And then we can turn back the clock just a few hours as well to take in some amazing football, certainly for Man U fans. In a thrilling Champions League clash, Harry Maguire's finally done it. His second half header secured a 1-0 victory for Man United against FC Copenhagen. And goalkeeper Andre Onana, just as important, his late penalty save, solidifying United's win, marking their first victory in the tournament this season. And I think a brief breath of fresh air for Erik ten Hag's side back in the competition after a year, now holding third place in Group A, earning three crucial points in their three games. Meanwhile, Bayern Munich looking pretty, leading the group 9 points following their 3-1 victory over Galatasaray. And that's where we leave our sporting headlines for this morning. Let's get one last look at the roads.
Thank you so much, G-Man. Yes, let's dive into traffic right now. One last time this morning, and in Gondwana, Mpumalanga is the area we're diving into right now, and there's been a truck accident on the N4. So please do avoid the affected area as heavy delays are expected. Now, moving over to Johannesburg, there's been an accident on the N3 northbound, and that's at London Road. Now, the right lane is closed, and there is slow-moving traffic in the area. From Johannesburg, we move over to Cape Town, and in Bellville, there is congestion on the N1 inbound at Yip de Jager Drive. So you can expect delays and allow for more travel time. For anybody else heading out on the roads, buckle up, stay safe, and plan accordingly. From the roads to the sky, let's see what's happening when it comes to weather. Reporting on weather news one last time this morning. Now, the SA Weather Service has warned that heat wave conditions resulting in persistently high temperatures exceeding average maximums are expected in places over Gauteng and the eastern parts of Northwest until Friday. Now, meanwhile, the death toll in the extreme weather in KwaZulu-Natal has risen to 8. Now, the latest two victims died after being struck by lightning in the Nkutu and Inkosi Langalabalele municipalities, and 5 people died during a storm at Mtubutabu over the weekend. Now, another person was also struck by lightning in the Mwakeni area in the KwaZulu-Natal Midlands. Our thoughts and condolences definitely go out to all those affected. For now, though, it's time to find out one last time what you can expect when it comes to temperatures in your side of town. Summer is on the horizon, the temperatures are increasing, and so are these morning views. Now, the next up for our sunrise view of the hour is Charmaine, who shared her view, and this is what she had to say. My view in Mbombela, Mpumalanga, taking a break from the ordinary and having a fabulous day. And look at this shot. It's like the promise of adventure, the promise of the eternal, and of course, just everything magic when it comes to this shot. Oh, I love it. It's very unique, very different, and I think this is why it's a winner this morning. So you want to be a winner yourself, Mzansi, come through, and we might be sharing your picture. The number is 063-408-8863. Why? Because we absolutely love seeing where you wake up and how you do in your side of town.
Raul, well, listen, this is your feel-good breakfast show. We're in the final hour, which means we still have loads to do. Now, Black Friday, it is next month, and Woolies have the ultimate Black Friday deals that they want to share with you. And then we're going to have some fun. We're going to do a bit of a challenge in the kitchen. How does a load-shedding sandwich challenge sound? That is still on its way. Welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. You are just in time because are you a bargain shopper? Well, you have come to the right place. It's Woolies' Black Friday, and this year we are giving us new deals every single week as we gear up to Black Friday. And here to help us with the best homeware deals is stylist and blogger Megan Pedro. Megan, I love that we get to talk deals because I'm here for a deal.
Deals and quality at Woolworths.
Deals and quality, that is key, definitely. Now, what advice do you have for people that love shopping deals like myself?
Okay, as a professional shopper myself, I take this very seriously. So I think that if we call out maybe three things, I would say that plan ahead. So make a list.
Make a list of your wish list.
Yes, throughout the year as well. I think it's quite nice to just kind of go, you know, which rooms and which kind of things do I want to, you know, add to, which is always nice. And then I think seasonally, it's quite important because actually a lot of the things that go on promo is for the next season or for a previous season. So it's actually quite interesting how you're not shopping for right now. So see the gaps in your home that you can kind of fill, which I think is quite interesting. And then, oh, I'm going to say put a budget aside. That's always a difficult one, but definitely try and do that.
Okay. I'm going to add a tip too. So we get so crazy. You see discount and this much off and sale, sale, sale. If you're not willing to pay for it full price, then don't buy it just because it's on sale. That's a tip I'll chip.
That's not goal maths though, but I like that.
Now, I love this because Woolworths Home, they have an amazing offer at the moment. Rewards members, they get 20% off design bedding. Talk us through these products. What is considered the design bedding that's currently on special?
So exactly that, what catches your eye. This is your design bedding. This is the beautiful Ikat, which is absolutely stunning. And I'm going to get into a couple of the key pieces at the moment. But Woolies, we've really perfected cottons, right? Mm-hmm. So we've talked about the Easy Care cottons, which is like your pre-washed, doesn't need ironing. Your 100% cottons, which is just absolutely luxurious and breathable for this upcoming season, which is lovely. And then your Egyptian cotton, which is luxurious to the max.
Don't put that in the tumble dryer. I learned the hard way.
Oh, no. Yeah. So then Black Friday, you need to replace.
Yeah, the king size fitted sheet is now a small bed.
Oh,
fitted sheet. Don't put it in the dryer. Now, I'm loving this beautiful setup that you have here. I know you love your neutrals, but this time we have a pop of color.
I love it. So again, as your shell in your home is more on the neutral side, it's always lovely to change from season to season with pops of color. So again, Ikat printed duvet. It's cotton, it's beautiful, it's breathable. What I love about it, it's reversible. So again, it's an instant change and your room feels different, but the pattern, again, pulling into Woolies' beautiful scatter cushions. Yeah. There are so many that you can play with, and then it obviously goes from room to room, which is so lovely. And then another one of my favorites, the Dobby quilt. Again, how does it pull in the color palette? It's just absolutely beautiful. And it's so luxurious and thick and lovely. I just absolutely love
it. Is this really called the Dobby quilt?
The Dobby quilt.
So if you're a Harry Potter fan, you'll find that absolutely adorable, the Dobby quilt.
You can kind of put it over you, just like, you know,
just like Dobby
would.
Yeah. Dobby gets a sock.
Yes.
Oh, this is amazing. So what are some of the other Black Friday deals that we can get from Woolworths?
I am really going to call out one in particular.
Okay.
And she's standing right here in front of me.
Ooh.
So the Sage Indie quilt. She speaks for herself, right? This is a breathable cotton. It is, I mean, actually, you should
just
feel this.
Pick it up.
Okay, the breathable cotton. Again, it's a neutral palette, which will live in any room in your home, but
yeah.
How absolutely luxurious. It's huge, so you can really get the whole family under it. Just the perfect movie night.
Oh, so is this one of the deals? This is what's 20% off for rewards members at the moment.
Yes. So all of the design bedding, this included.
Oh, well, there we go. Ladies and gentlemen, Woolworths is giving you deals that you do not want to miss out on. Rewards members, you get 20% off design bedding from now until the 29th of October. Shop this deal at Woolworths. You can shop it in-store, online, as well as on the app. There are T's and C's that can be found on woolworths.co.za. Meg, if you had to pick one thing right now that you can run offset with, what would you choose? The Dobby quilt. I'm going to choose this, and I think we're allowed to run off in there. Maybe they won't notice it's gone.
I don't think they will.
Okay.
Totally not.
We'll just walk off.
Okay.
Yeah.
Feel the freshness with Albany in your trolley and look forward to the perfect bread for an imperfect world, let's be honest, no matter what the occasion. So today, we're back in our beautiful new kitchen and we are going to be having a whole lot of fun, of course, with Albany Bakeries. They are just amazing. And today, we are going to be making the ultimate dun-dun-dun sandwich. Uh-oh, what's going on? What's going on? Where have the lights gone? What's going on?
I guess we're not.
Oh, no.
We have a generator.
Oh, no, don't we? Where's
we
the generator? Did we not pay the bill? What's going on, guys? There it is. The load shedding hits us again, but fear not, because with Albany, you can still whip up something truly delicious and wholesome. Hopefully, Ryle. Okay, so this is the deal. Ooh. The challenge is simple. We're going to put the fiercest competitors we have on set, Ryle and Zozo, at it once again. And they're going to have just 2 minutes to create the ultimate load shedding sandwich with ingredients provided and a nice array at that. And of course, using anything and everything. And most importantly, I want you to feel the freshness. How many slices you use is up to you. Oh. Zoe, at what point of this week or last week or this month did you get into Ryle's head to start beating him?
No, I sometimes, you know, when I leave the show and I'm like, maybe I was mean to Ryle.
Yes,
like,
you were. No, you were. You were very mean.
To him?
On Monday, she planted the seed and somehow I'm going to lose now. It's just inevitable.
Look, I know he's the nicest guy that you could meet, but he's also highly competitive. And
he
I think
is.
You've beaten that out of him. But no, so this is the deal, guys. You've got your freshness in front of you, our beautiful Albany bread. You've got an amazing array of ingredients.
I know
we can't
chocolate,
see much.
By the way?
You know, you're going to have to taste to find out.
Wow.
Buddy, in the dark, nobody knows.
So you're gonna,
I look forward to some interesting combinations here. I want to see pickled something with peanut butter. Just do it. No, you've got the balance. You've got the bread. Let's have some fun. Ladies and gentlemen, you have 2 minutes to create the ultimate load-shedding sami. 3, 2, 1. Take
let's
it away.
Go.
Don't waste time.
Come on,
don't waste time
go.
Talking, bro. Right.
What's the goal here? To make it the most delicious or the best looking?
I think
how
a bit of both,
this?
My friend. I think a sandwich's
both.
Value lies in its
these
kind of ocular and its taste. So you want to look good because we eat with the eyes first.
Okay.
See, she beat you already. You went with 2 slices, okay. She went with 4.
If you avoid butter, you can use mayo as
okay,
a substitute.
Well done.
You use your sauce as a butter.
And doing the smell test in load shedding is perfectly fine,
you
guys.
Have to if taste you have to do
the smell taste, just go for it.
Go for some cheese spread here.
Okay, what's next? I love that avo base. I'm all about the avo on sandwich.
Yeah, I love mixing up the fats when you put it on there and you spread it on bread. And it's obviously the fact that you're so used to butter. But like Zoe says, there's so many other options that we can incorporate.
You want to use that? So there's a guy, Willie Harcourt Coos, which is responsible for like the rebirth of cacao and like the traditional chocolate making style.
Yeah.
And I did an amazing culinary show with him, and he would put avo butter on toast with dark chocolate shavings and a fried egg with a little bit of chili flakes on top. One of the best things I've ever tasted. So don't be shy of mixing. We've got a little bit of time left, 30 seconds on the clock, I think. Come on, that's looking great. I'm seeing two layers there.
I'm very hungry, so let's do a chicken mayo.
Oh, Zoe is overachieving with 2 sandwiches. Wow, she just brings it every time. And Albany is bringing real back to real life and reminding South Africans that bread is at the center of some of the most beautiful and simple and delicious everyday moments, even in the not so good times. Like I say, the perfect bread for an imperfect world. You've got 20 seconds left, guys. They are challenging the stereotype by celebrating real people, real bread moments and real life by removing unrealistic expectations of perfectionism and enjoying bread in a way that reflects the lives of South Africans. I dig that. There's a diverse range of obviously bread products to choose from, including white, we've got brown, we've got best of both, my favorite, I think. And additionally, they've got a great range of buns and rolls and wraps now as well. And we are done.
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 Oh yeah. I'm feeling good about this.
Yeah,
bro.
I like your little eyes that you put in there as well.
let me do that reveal for the camera.
Oh, look at that.
You can do it. Dun, dun, dun. Beautiful.
Beautiful.
Okay, Zoe, talk me through your creation here.
So I made 4 sandwiches. Two sandwiches cut in half, which makes 4. So the traditional chicken mayo, but added some pickled and cheese.
Well, that can be good.
That's option one.
Those are my 2 favorites. I love chicken mayo and I love cheese and tomato.
And then we also love a good old, you know, veggie sandwich. So I've got some cheese, tomato, and then added some salad, but also added some cheese spread just to get it, like, not too dry.
Yeah, the unctuousness, as Carl Wasey, our good mate, would say. I absolutely love it. So you've done yourself proud, and I think they would be happy on any menu. Ral, what's going on here, my bro?
I was trying to obviously do one up on a sandwich. Obviously, I can't beat four sandwiches, but I did, like, a little triple-decker here.
I love it.
So I've got, like, the best of both. So everyone loves, like, a good chicken salmi. Right, mm-hmm. So I've got like a little bit of a chicken avo mix there, some lettuce, and then I pop that in the middle. Then I've gone for the next layer being, and this is crazy, this is where it gets crazy. I've mixed the chicken and the tuna, so on the top layer we've got tuna. I've made the tuna fresh, right, so I've add some pickles to it. I've added some cheese and some cucumber and tomato. So like a fresh sort of a club, think of a club salad.
Ark. No,
I love it. No, and that's got every one of my dietary requirements sorted,
all your
buddy. I love it.
Boxes ticked,
so
man.
That being said, I think I've got an unhealthy enjoyment of food right now because I'm idolizing it. So I don't think I'm the right person to taste. Yeah, because this all looks amazing. I'll taste that pickle, look amazing. So I need to bring in our chief here. Lushi Poo, please step in here, my brother. Lushi, you're gonna
have
I know.
Triple decker.
And a quadruple decker.
If I had known Lucian was the judge, I would have made it extra liquor, you know? Like,
yeah. Why are you saying that?
I know you have a specific taste profile. Let's just say that.
I'm going to be that person. Lucian, mine's on a plate.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but don't forget the rustic experience here.
Don't let it get into your head.
No,
don't let it get into
first.
Your head.
Huh?
Okay, so go for it. So I want on the look and the flavor. Okay, so we'll give you... You're right to...
Oh, you're doing both? It's two separate sandwiches. Like, let's not...
Oh, come on. He could have done it all.
Could have done it.
Come
I'll back on.
Him. Oh, man. I'd still like to know who cuts. Go for it. It's all about that flavor now. Hey? Flavor
TV,
is...
You know, our producer's saying to you, TV bite edition.
Has anyone on the show ever done a TV bite?
Ain't nobody got time for that, man.
Nice.
When the food looks
and
this good,
sandwich
and it looks this good and it tastes this good, you cannot take a TV bite. It's too tempting.
Okay.
So going with the fresh one now.
Fresh.
It's not vegan, it's veggie. And it looks... really, really impressive by the amount that Lucian
is dancing. So that's
okay.
A good sign. If he's got a dancing, that's a good sign.
Sure, open to account, very strong. Okay, so you've got a thumbs up. So a strong start. I'm going to ask you.
I left him speechless.
I'm going to ask you, which never happens. No, that's not going to happen. A rating out of 10 for both.
Okay, the first one out of 10, I'll give it a nice solid 8.
Okay.
The flavors are very, very, very good, and I like the combination
with
all the pickles and onion. It's just the bomb.
Okay.
Second one, I love the freshness of all the ingredients that you put on regarding them. Yeah.
There's cheese spread and cheese.
Cucumber, the tomato, and the lettuce. Fresh, love it, and the cheese. So,
okay.
Ral, your turn.
Okay, so we're looking at an 8 there. Solid 8 for Zozo.
You've got to be open-minded,
the whole thing?
No, just have the left-hand side or the right-hand side, whichever you choose. But yes, the whole stack together.
Do the whole thing.
The whole stack together.
I want to see you get that, please.
It's an experience. Be open-minded.
Don't
and understand that this has never been done before. Chicken and tuna together.
Don't be humble, yeah.
Groundbreaking.
Chicken and tuna.
Yeah.
He's looking after our protein needs.
He looked scared there.
I know.
Hey, easy. Easy.
I feel like we need to put the mic in his face.
Come on, can I feel a little bit of a dance? A little bit of...
Am I going to have to hold him, catch him?
Why are you looking at me like that?
He's pulling a face.
Why are you looking at me like that?
Okay.
Chicken and tuna.
Yeah. Great, eh?
Protein.
Life...
different ones. No.
Life-changing?
No.
You left out one of the
that is amazing.
Brew.
It tastes great. I love it.
Just too weird.
Well, those are really eating.
Oh.
You guys did a phenomenal job. I would go with Zoe, but you guys did a great
but
job.
Okay.
Oh, well done. Okay, I'm
Best
taking this one for
okay.
myself.
Okay.
I've got it. So, ladies
I'll
and gentlemen,
I'll take it.
Not that it was any surprise at all, but the winner of our load-shedding sandwich challenge is Zoe Brown. And she gets to eat her rewards. Don't look so smug. You could be one of the lucky 7 viewers who could have that smug look on your face when you walk away with a 1,000 Rand cash prize. All you got to do, reply to the competition question on the Expresso Facebook, Instagram, or X pages, formerly known as Twitter, obviously, and tell us, what is your go-to load-shedding sandwich? You've seen how far we can push that boat out. Don't forget to hashtag it, MyPerfectAlbany, in that entry. And, of course, your X entrance, remember to share the post, please. There is an opportunity there. Competition closes Friday at 10 a.m., so you don't have a huge amount of time. So get cracking. Make those sandwiches, and we want to see you eat them with as much vigor and joy as our captain does. Well done.
Anyone want my sandwich? Anybody
I'm
hungry?
Gonna try now.
Oh, yeah, we want to take
come on, protein.
Yeah.
Bro.
Yeah.
It's my feel good breakfast show.
Oh, welcome back. Oh, Ryle, I'm so sorry, man. In case you missed it, yes, Zoe beat Ryle again. Have you ever beat? No, I don't. Don't even answer that. Listen, like Ryle, we all have fantasies about what we would do if we randomly received a large amount of money. I think this time of the year, most of us thinking about that every day, pretty much.
Praying for
it. So let's find out what we would actually do in another round of Would You Rather?
Give us a scenario.
Okay, so this is a cool one. This is really easy. You receive $1 million. It's not enough to retire immediately, but you do have some options. So, would you rather, A, upgrade your house and car and maybe change jobs, use it as a little fast forward, or B, change nothing, pay off your debt, and live more comfortably?
Sounds easy.
If I can just jump in.
I'm not actually giving you the money, sorry, unfortunately, but you can go for it.
I would do B. I would keep living life. I think you can easily get caught up in a million.
I'll spend $1 million in a month, yo. Mm.
But it I would pay it towards my bond.
Yeah, 100%.
Reduce
yeah.
that.
I think this question definitely is based on where you're at in your journey, right? If you don't have a vehicle, you don't have a house, I would definitely say put this towards an asset. So maybe not the car, but definitely put it towards our house. And I would say choose A. But in my personal situation, B all the way. I don't think we need to be chasing materialistic things right now. I think we can really afford to improve our quality of life. And this is how you can do it.
I would literally put it in an account called interest rate. And just leave it there to balance out. Because any debt that you have, you've been through it. Any debt that you're going to have or having right now, nice. You've been through it. We don't know what is happening. So I think we've found our stasis now, our homeostasis, if you want. I love that. I love the notion of clearing debt. We've carried a lot of that pressure for too long now, and I think it is a really good opportunity for people to understand that you free yourself when you take those big, heavy burdens off your shoulders. But I think we are not the experts. Of course, you guys are the experts. So let's see what you are thinking at home.
Okay. Luxina. Says option B, take your money seriously. Boom. Adele also saying option
B. Labushane. Adele, before we get kicked out of the country. Yeah.
The table changing things up, saying A, upgrade of my house and car, maybe change job. Okay.
The table's young. You see, it's young and hungry.
Definitely. Yeah. Corbis comes through. I will go definitely with B. We need to turn every cent around these days. So obviously feeling the pressure there. Marlene Wilson says, morning, I'll definitely go for B. # take your money seriously.
And people are taking their money seriously. Like Megan says, change nothing, pay off debts and live comfortably.
Mm-hmm.
I think everyone's been through it. You know, when I speak to mates of mine, and I remember having this conversation, I've got a really successful mate. And you think, you're fine. But think of the pressure when you've got that much to lose. It doesn't matter where you sit. South Africans are feeling the pinch, feeling the pressure. So if we can be more responsible and just take that money seriously, move it out of the zone of it's nice to have when I can have it or I'll spend it when I've got it, just set that aside. Take your money seriously so you can earn it and look after it. And when it comes to money, there is never a right answer. Mm. It's what's right for you. But we hope that you would rather choose the scenario that gets you thinking a bit more seriously about your own financial well-being and not just that immediate enrichment and helping you weigh out the various pros and cons of any financial decision or gateway in your life. Like you said, different season, but you need to still take your money seriously.
Mabel, check this. With a MyGold's premium account, you get 12 free airport lounge visits.
12?
Yeah.
God of it. When are you busy planning your next getaway during office hours? Aman.
Oh, well, listen, with the warmer weather here, some of us have already switched from winter bedding to lighter summer bedding. I was that person. You just get too hot under the winter bedding if you do have different bedding for every season. You. Now, changing our bedding, washing it and packing it away in the linen cupboard, it is quite a task. You want to set a whole day aside for it. And our beds are a place of comfort and rest after a long day. It is so important to keep it feeling fresh for high quality sleep. So for today's home hacks, we are going to look at ways to make the process easier, neater and more organized. With this, to chat with these home tips for us, we have tips and tricks from stylist and blogger Megan Pedro joining us so that we can be as savvy
as possible.
Yes, Meg, come through, because this is a department that I need to step up, definitely. Okay. Because we had a challenge with Zoe. I couldn't even get the freaking thing inside of the cover. So I've got a lot of work to do. Come through and serve me right now. Let's start with like a basic thing, like let's say folding. Okay. I know there's a lot of options, a lot of ways to fold correctly, okay. How to fold things away. How do we get that like corner in and stuff like that? You got anything for us?
Yes, I do.
Hospital or hotel corner?
Oh, yes, exactly. So I went to hotel school, right? So
okay.
We had to fold quite a few of these. I do prefer that, you know, the hospitality side of the corner as opposed to the hospital corner. But essentially, I feel like it's the closest thing that you have to like a little getaway, because when you go to a hotel, you get into that like crisp bedding, and then you get home and you wonder why on earth it's not like that, right? Okay. So it's a smooth, beautiful, edged like corner that just is so snug and easy. It's super easy, and it makes it neat, it makes it tidy.
And it's on the screen right now. Look at that. It's just a simple tucking formation. Did you see that?
I saw that, but I've never seen it in my bedroom ever, so I'm hoping I can try to replicate that. I'm gonna have to watch that video again. That was really, really cool. I see what you've done there. Nice.
Now, Megan, our next question is, you know, a fitted sheet, it's got the elastics, it doesn't have perfect corners. Mm-hmm. How can we fold our laundry?
Okay.
Give us a hack.
I love this one, right. So a fitted sheet is always the one that gets crumbled up into the, you know, into the laundry cupboard. So this is the one that, you know, has these. Ryle's already like, oh no.
I feel like that's a two-man job.
Is that a big shower cap? What's that?
Okay, so essentially you're gonna lay it down with those corners.
Okay, do you need some help? Are you good?
So this is the hack.
This is a one-man job.
Okay, there's lots of fluffs, but we go. Okay. So towards you like this.
In the corners.
You're gonna go into the other corners.
Like little gloves.
So you meet the corners up with the corners you already have around your hand. Okay, got that, yeah.
It's gonna lay down like that. And then look, this essentially already
becomes
wraps
a soft square.
A soft square,
soft rectangle.
So I mean, it's already sorted for you. So there's none of those like edges that just absolutely work on everybody's nerves.
Look at that. Cupboard.
Nice. Aww. Okay. That kind of makes sense. And I would imagine when people are starting to incorporate some of these beautiful colors, like I see Woolies has all these different, like sort of subtle, different shades of earthy tones. Mm-hmm. How would we sort of fold this in a way where we can kind of see, oh yeah, I want to get that orange one now. I want to get the mustard one. Is there a way that we can, instead of, because I know when it comes to like choosing sheets, you kind of like dig in the, I haven't used this one in the corner in a long time. And oh no, it's not that one. Let me grab another. Oh no, sir. Is there a way we can kind of compartmentalize this so that we have a better visual of what we're selecting in the cupboard?
Sure. Often your towels are also in your laundry cupboard, right?
Yeah.
So that also gets all like intertangled. So what's so nice, what I love to do is take your pillowcase, okay?
Okay.
And so you've got your, you know, your duvet cover, you've got your fitted sheet, everything that's in that color palette.
Yeah.
You fold it all inside.
Pillowcase.
Then your pillowcase is inside your cupboard, and you can see that that entire bed set is there.
That
Where
is
have you been all these
years?
What? Okay.
See, this is why we brought her. So on your screen right now, you can see a great way to store a bedding set by using the pillowcase as the baggie. Because I know if you go to Woolies now and you buy your bedding, it doesn't come in plastic anymore. It now comes in a cute little baggie that I've been
that
keeping. Because
well.
I'm like, I'm going to find a purpose for this bag.
And it sticks with the colorways, which is so nice. So that's why it's so easy. You pick the color palette that you want and whole sets together. Your two pillows, everything.
I love that. Okay, well played. Coming through with some tips, is there anything else that I'm missing out on? Because this is overwhelming for me, to be honest.
Okay.
There's a lot to take in when it comes to making it look as hotel ready as you are able to. But we're talking scents, I'm assuming.
Yeah. Well, okay, close.
Yes,
so you're going to add a scent to this. So this essentially is water, fabric softener, and you can add an essential oil.
Ooh.
What is so lovely is if you don't like ironing, I'm not a huge fan of ironing, my husband does the ironing, this is so simple. So you've got the solution in here, and then you're spritzing it over your bedding, of course.
Your dry bedding once it's on the bed.
Yes. So if it is creased, you spritz it over there, and you pull at the edges, and it will smooth it out.
Just smooth it out.
But you do it on your clothes, too.
I'm going to put all my clothing on the bed. Are you serious?
You can do it on your clothing, and then you hang it in the shower. Literally on the outside of the shower, and you have a nice steam shower, it will take out those creases.
Oh,
smells amazing.
Brilliant.
It's a perfect hack.
Oh,
okay,
that is a great hack. Oh, well, I feel like now you've given us all the hacks that we need. Mm-hmm. Should we do a bit of a challenge?
Yes. So let the domestic princesses step aside. Let's call in. Babe, can you represent for our house?
Capitan in the building.
So,
Ryle,
you're so this is House Espresso versus House Pedro. Is that what it is?
Wow, look, Pedro versus the Espresso.
I've got a tight suit on here, so I don't have my range.
No, you can't come with excuses.
I don't have range, bro. Come on.
You can take your suit off.
No, I can't. It's stuck. Okay, so we're doing the are we doing the full challenge that you just presented to us, right?
Yes. Okay, I'm going to count down.
Okay, wait. Are we gonna? How much time are we giving them? Just whoever finishes first.
1 minute.
1 minute.
What are we looking for? Like pristine corners and size and like
the one that looks the neatest.
Yes. Yes. Okay. You ready?
Are you ready?
Yeah.
No pressure here.
No pressure.
Pay more attention.
Okay. Your time begins in three, two, one. Let's go. There we go. 60 seconds on the clock. Okay. Team Pedro against House Espresso. Which household's going to win?
Wow.
Which house? Ryle, don't disappoint me here.
Wow.
Just add a mask.
Just make it a square. Make it a square. Did you not see what Megan did?
I'm not going to be biased.
Tuck it in.
Oh.
When you have Zoe in your corner, things just make sense.
Fold it again. You've got 30 seconds. No, 35 seconds.
Clem, are you breathing? Are you talking?
I'm not even breathing. Okay. I'm sorry. I forgot that you guys were all here.
Why can't I do this challenge?
I still got time to spritz this thing up.
Yeah.
Go, you've got 25 seconds. Go, Ryle.
Let me just...
and straighten it out.
Baby did the same today. Oh, wow.
Clem, do you need some help there, bro?
Oh.
Excuse me, do you have a spare garage in your home to put the fitted sheet that Ryle has folded for you? Or do you simply have a pocket?
Two.
A pocket.
One. Time is up.
I went with that, like, that poofy, inviting look, you know?
Yeah.
Cupboard look. Okay.
Okay, I feel like I'm being biased here, but how do we choose a winner? Because, you mean, you want to choose your husband. I want Team Espresso to win, but that one looks smaller.
Which one do you want to put in your linen cabinet? The truth.
Viewers, maybe tell us, actually.
No, I'll be honest. I'll be dead honest. The one that's going to fit in my cupboard is that one.
You need to get bigger cupboards,
though. Because you need to... I need a whole laundry room if Ryle's doing laundry.
Oh, wow.
Seriously, thank you, though. I have never had any clue on even how to do this. Clearly, I have a little bit of work to do. This is what I'm saying. I had no idea, but I have a little bit of work to do. I need to pay more attention, but already this is progress for me.
100%.
If you've seen what it did look like, that's definitely progress.
So
thank you for coming.
Ryle, you did good.
Thanks, so.
That's the best-looking swirl cast I've ever seen. Wow!
Okay, well, listen, it's safe to say the Pedros took this
round. I want to say thank you to Meg, obviously, for sharing your betting organization and styling wisdom with us. I've needed this, and I'm going to keep working on this. I hope you are, too. And there's nothing better than feeling fresh after a shower, bath, and climbing into a newly made bed after a stressful day. And hopefully these tips and tricks inspire you to give yourself some sleep self-care. All right, I'm going to try this again.
Welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, Espresso on S3. This picture, it's not me yawning, it's me looking shocked because not to freak
freak you out, this morning we have revealed that there are only 60 days until Christmas, and we've been seeing some festivities popping up, and you can also see it in stores, and hopefully that doesn't freak you out. So we asked you, have you already thought of gifts, started saving for them, bought some perhaps? Let's see what you had to say on social media.
Oh, yeah, comments coming through thick and fast. Tracy Paulson says, good morning, Espresso Morning Show. SABC3, oh yeah, 9 weeks to Christmas. My shopping is 80% done.
Oh, wow, even before Black Friday.
Here's some tips, that's incredible
stuff. That is
stuff.
Incredible. Marlene says, good morning, Espresso family. Looking forward to it because we overcome so much the past years.
Nice.
Just to be in contact with your family and friends and to celebrate. Yes, this is always so special. It's that one time of the year where everyone from all corners of South Africa come together.
I think that in its own is already the gift, and I think the presents are just the cherry on the top. Sylvia Raymond says, scary how this year flew past. I know, but it's real. Putting up Christmas decorations the end of October.
Yes.
Right, so that's pretty soon. We're almost at the end of October right now, so I think you're starting off with that. I've seen all these decorations come through in the shops already. It's getting me excited for the season. I am trying my best not to spend money on gifts. I'm trying to make things, create things, and get a bit more arty and crafty. So hopefully that works out, and hopefully they are appreciated as well. I mean, I've got work to do, clearly, as you can see from my folding skills.
It's fine. You know what you could do is bake cookies and then just put them in a little jar and put a bow around that. That's quite a special touch.
I love that.
I like chocolate chip.
Okay, got you. Nudge. So to come through, let us know what tips you have. And of course, maybe we can serve you for the rest of the 60 days that are happening up until Christmas. I can't believe it. But right now, let's catch up with what else we can expect in the show.
Oh, I want you to get ready for an epic showdown in the heart of summer. Our very own Kutleo, I think, is up for this challenge. And the one and only Primo are about to go head-to-head in the ultimate in-store summer paycation challenge with Game. It's going to be a battle of wits, creativity, and yes, strategy, all to bring you the best summer deals. We can get excited about Christmas right now. Take a look.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Game Store Summer Vacation Challenge. Namhlanje, I will be going head-to-head against the clock to select the hottest summer items from poolside fun to braai essentials. So let's go meet up with our challenger today, the one and only hilarious Primo. Our challenger Namhlanje is running late, but I'm not complaining.
Okay, my darling.
I'm gonna use this time to get ahead of the game. Okay, what should I go for?
I think the ironing board, maybe.
Look who we have here. Primo, how are you?
I'm great. And yourself, Kutle?
I'm good. A bit tense because obviously we're going head to head.
Yeah, I hope you're ready for me.
Sort of. How are you feeling?
So confident. I mapped this all out for my summer.
Really? Ooh. How have you been spending your summer vacation?
Can I tell you, I'm buying, I'm splurging. I'm just buying.
So you haven't saved?
You've been saving the whole year, Kutle.
Well, to be fair, if you're spending low prices, you're saving.
Kind of already. Yeah, the job is done.
Yeah, balance.
two birds with one stone.
So what is your plan going into today's challenge?
I want to make my summer as cool as possible.
Yeah.
It's really hot.
It is.
I'm going to be focusing on making my environment comfy. Mm.
Yeah. Primo and I have 10 minutes to select the hottest summer items here in the store. So Sis Kumutso will be judging us based on two criteria, creativity and, of course, practicality. Are you ready?
I'm ready for you. Are you?
Okay, your time starts now. Go!
No, wait. No. No, that's not fair. That's not fair. Oh my. This is a perfect one, especially if you want to be in the pool. Let's go find some more items.
A speaker, so my neighbors are going to hate me.
7 minutes left.
I thought 10 minutes was like enough.
A fan gets rid of flies, heat, yonke into at the same time. I don't have to lie on the floor.
What do people use in the garden? This?
Take this one. Oh.
I can't lose out to Primo.
And the best thing about this one, the Springboks, we're definitely taking the World Cup. I've got a fan, I've got sound, cooler box. Do you mind hosting a braai or being the braai master at someone else's braai?
Braai master.
Braai master, ne? Exactly.
What else? What else? What else? What else?
See this thing? It's a chair, it cools your drinks, it holds your phone, it holds everything.
Isama vacation items is a go pical. Hey, Koneni, that's exactly where I come from. So let's go back. Oh. Watch where you're going.
No indicators.
You're in my way.
You're driving here.
Oh my gosh, Primo, you're wasting my time.
See, this is how you cheat.
No ways.
I think Kutle is doing well.
We have got. Oh, it's a blow up pool mattress.
I'll find it.
There.
I want to lama pin gune taspin in na. If mara ingane.
I thought 10 minutes was enough, but definitely not.
1 minute left.
One minute. Okay. Yes.
And
go. 30 seconds.
Not 30 seconds. Not on my watch.
15 seconds
five,
to find my killer product.
3, 2, 1. Bomb shopping.
I'm done. Primo, Primo, the time is up. Stop the clock. 10 minutes has been over. What's up with you and time?
Can
Primo?
I tell you? Yes. 10 minutes is like the new 1 minute.
Literally.
Come on, man.
I was sweating my makeup off. But listen, I am dead at the first.
Well, remember I told you I wanted comfort.
Yes.
So I realized I don't want comfort only for myself, but yes. I want for my friends.
Yes.
So I got my bri pack because I'm going to be the bri master. I'm not brying. See, then I got a cooler box.
Yes.
See, this one, obviously for drinks and stuff, but it's one of the most versatile objects you can get. Why?
It serves as a chair.
I got a fan. I've got a springboard cam chair, obvious. My kumba kumba sound. I'm hosting. My secret weapon. You see this, right? It's a bin. Obviously, I'm gonna clean up after everybody.
Yes.
But there's too many friends, too many drinks.
Yes.
We say water in the bin, ice. We've got a huge cooler box.
I am done.
It's too hot. We take the drinks out. I get inside. I am cool in the box. So what do you have in there? Let's see if you can beat me, because I think mine is solid.
So obviously, a cute little cooler box that can fit in the car wherever we're going.
Cute.
I'm thinking about the garden to keep it fresh, you know, and nice for the summer when people are hanging out. We've got the umbrella.
You have a yard, you know?
Of course. And then this one is my special one. Why? Once again, to keep the lawn and the garden.
Just sounds like
clean. Sizhumuto, we have justified our items, ne?
And the winner is Primo!
Come on!
Why?
Thanks to this guy.
That's your winning item right there.
Yes. My secret weapon.
You know what? I can't even hate. I have to ask, what's your summer jam that you're going to play on that big Goomba Goomba speaker
of yours?
See,
the first thing I do, I'm going to put my cam chair out.
Yeah.
My dustbin, Goomba Goomba on. Zing, zong, na zeng.
You did so well. I love your items. You truly do deserve the title of the Game Store's Summer Vacation Challenge Champion. Woo! Now, until next time, from Primo and I, we want to say please enjoy your summer adventures and stay cool.
Well, clearly Primo's got game, but Kutle, you still got all the game we need. And thank you to both of you for highlighting some amazing deals. I am going to head out to game this afternoon to start plotting my son's birthday or his Christmas wish list. Amazing deals on offer, not just for Christmas, but every single day, and unbelievable value as well. Kutle, well done, girl.
All right, so I'm trying to do what Joshua Williams is doing right now from Paddock Company, and I think I'm stuck. Hang on. So I'm going to leave it up to the professionals, clearly, because this man's got range, he's got strength, and he's got balance, and we are so excited for the Queen Show, which is happening starting today. So every reason to get excited. We're going to have a performance from them in just a bit, and oh, let me tell you, you want to get your tickets and gaze and admire all of this talent. We'll see you there.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Oh, yes, Mzansi, welcome back to your feel-good breakfast show. And if you were listening to me earlier, let me tell you, this is absolutely magic what these people are up to. We're here on the Expresso stage this morning with some dancers from the Johannesburg-based Mzansi Ballet. Now, this is Joshua Williams. The man has done incredible things. You won a scholarship in the 2016, I think it was the SA International Ballet Competition, and that obviously took you to Zurich to further training. That's incredible.
Yeah.
Can we just take a moment to acknowledge that? What was that experience like for you? I mean, how did that impact your journey? Obviously, a long time has passed since then, but oh, you have just gone above and beyond. Yeah.
No, it was the experience was such a fun and challenging experience. I don't think I would have gotten the training that I got there like anywhere else. Like, it grew me so much as a dancer from where I started, because I started out my kind of dance career here in Cape Town, and I started with hip-hop. Actually, I didn't go into ballet in the beginning, so I just wanted to do hip-hop in the beginning because I like dancing. And then after that, our studio with Tamsin Williams moved into modern dancing, and I really enjoyed modern dancing and contemporary. And then after that, she wanted me to get stronger in my technique, so she recommended me to Karin and Johan Joester on the West Coast Dance Academy at the West Coast. And then I did a year and a half of ballet, and then from there they wanted to take a chance on me and then just offered me the opportunity to join the SAIBC with Dirk Badenhorst, who's actually my director now. So it kind of came a bit full circle after that. So I did the competition and I got the scholarship, which was such an amazing experience. And then after that, in 2020, I came back to do the production of Queen, and since then I've been with the company.
Absolutely incredible. Well, you are a testament of all this hard work. Quick one before we start this performance.
Yes.
Where can people buy these tickets? I believe the show is starting today.
The show is starting today, so 25th of October, and it goes until the 11th of November, and people can get the tickets on webtickets.co.za, and they can just get it online.
Oh, well, let me grab this from you because... yes, congratulations. Let me grab this from you because, ladies and gentlemen, right now, this is Joshua Williams. He's about to do a solo performance. It's on Bohemian Rhapsody by The Queen Show, and this is Joshua Williams taking it away.
Mama just killed a man, put a gun against his head, pulled my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life had just begun.
Incredible. Please take a bow. Absolutely majestic.
Oh
buddy, I think ballet is a different sport. It's a different art now. The level of athleticism is just insane. But the artistic ability, beautiful. Thank you so much.
Wow. I officially have new goals. I want to get my strength and my flexibility on that level. And I definitely think everything else was sorted out. The box has been ticked when it comes to entertainment. And Mzansi, thank you for joining us this morning. I absolutely love spending my time with you.
And of course, you can go and see this for yourself, The Queen Show, with that incredible soundtrack and those phenomenal dancers on at the Theatre on the Bay, Camps Bay, from the 25th. So it's kicking off right now up until the 11th of next month. Go and do it. Tickets are super cheap. To plug into this level of talent, you need it. And of course, if you want to plug into the silliness and madness and insanity of this lot, you can do it all over again tomorrow morning. Oh, we love you guys.
That was incredible. Well, listen, make sure you get your tickets. They are available at Web Tickets. And let's support the Mzansi Ballet in Cape Town.
We'll see you guys tomorrow. Have an amazing day. Stay safe. Stay blessed. Love you.
Another feel-good production.